How do you design one of the most advanced ERs in the country? At Parkview, we did it by focusing all our attention on you, the patient, by involving doctors and nurses in the design process, by creating quieter, more private spaces, and by leading the region in heart, stroke, and trauma care. This is not your typical emergency room. It's Parkview. In an emergency, isn't this where you'd rather be?
Parkview, your partner in health.
Both teams, both Bishop Luers and Bishop Dwenger, and all of our listeners on Redeemer Radio, may they be blessed and know of your love. We ask all this through Christ our Lord, as we say, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Father Bob. Back up to you guys.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Sean McBride here, joined by Joe Wharton up here in the box. On the field, we have Nick Gray and the Godfather of Football, Coach Dave X. Excited to bring you a live tailgate talk that started at 6 o'clock, finishing with four great interviews, two players, Anton Berry and Frankie Yanko, both from Bishop Luers and Bishop Dwenger there. And again, the head coaches, Kyle Lindsay and Chris Schwarzkopf, both again from Luers and Dwenger. And the Battle of the Bishops, Joe, again, every year you can throw the records out. You can say what you will about both teams. But this is a huge game for both the squads, not only for the gold helmets, but the men wearing red and black as well.
It's a great game, Sean. You got that right. Listen, Luers, you and I both picked them preseason to win the SAC. That's not going to happen. But they are trending in the right direction. They've won the last two games, Sean, 2 weeks ago being Northside, 49-28, and then last week, of course, throttling Northrop, 63-49. The Saints, on the other hand, Casey O'Boyle picked them to win the SAC at the beginning of the year, and they're going to need a lot of help to get that done. But the Saints lost 36-21 to Carroll 2 weeks ago, and a heartbreaker to Concordia, 28-21 just last week. So this is going to be real interesting, and I think it boils down to this, Sean, with the wet track, who's going to be able to effectively run the ball. You look at the two fine backs for Bishop Luers, Jalen Charlton and Hambright. Charlton averaging 12 yards a carry, Hambright nearly 8 yards a carry. And that stingy Bishop Dwenger Saints run defense, the number two defense in the SAC, are only giving up 2 yards per carry. It's going to be a great matchup in the trenches.
We're getting ready to go down to the sideline or the midfield here as the entire crowd prepares for an opening prayer. We're going to step out for a 30-second break. We'll be back for the national anthem shortly. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio 106.3 FM.
Make a difference in your life and others by joining. Every great team has focus and talent, and at Parkview Sports Medicine, our focus is on you. From performance training and nutrition counseling to orthopedic surgery, athletic rehab, and more, Parkview Sports Medicine's got you covered. You can trust us to bring together today's top experts in sports medicine to improve the performance and treatment of athletes like you. Go to parkview.com/sportsmedicine to learn how we can help you and the athletes in your life be your best. Parkview Sports Medicine, upgrade your game.
Please remain standing for the half to sing our national anthem, which will be sung tonight by the senior members of the Bishop Luers Choral Department.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Beautiful rendition of our national anthem there, brought to you by students at Bishop Luers High School. And we are ready to kick this one off here just moments away of the Battle of the Bishops 2016. Let's check in on the sidelines with the godfather of football, who has field conditions and the coin toss result.
Hey guys, the field down here tonight is looking great. The dads, as usual, have got it looking good, and it feels solid. I got out there and put my big size 15s to work out there. No wind to speak of tonight that I can see. And on the coin toss, Dwenger Saints won the toss and decided to receive. So the Knights will be kicking towards the school away from the scoreboard. Back up to you guys.
All right, Dave X, thanks very much for that report. It is leaky out here, but we see some breaks in the clouds. Still some rain is threatening throughout the night. We'll keep you up to speed on that one. But mid-60s here, Joe, and a really nice night out here for the Battle of the Bishops.
Yeah.
And let's talk a little bit about keys to victory. One of the things that we really need to stress tonight, both of these teams not really where they want to be, but Bishop Luers on the uptick with two wins in a row. What do the Knights have to do to overcome the Bishop Dwenger Saints today?
Well, I think they're going to need balance. They're going to have some. They're going to have to be effective in the passing game. Senior Arian Nieves is getting the start, Sean. He's been out since week three with a leg injury, so Nieves comes in getting the start here on senior night. So we're going to see if there's any rust that he needs to knock off of that throwing arm in the passing game. Remember in the first two games when he struggled a little bit in the first two games, only completing 45% of his passes. He had no touchdowns and two interceptions. That gives him a quarterback rating of 21, which is not real good. So we're going to see if he can jump out here on senior night and make something happen. But we're going to have to wait to see him, because we're going to see the Saints offense first. Blake Pichelny. Of course, this will be an offense without Amon Clark, who is out injured tonight. He got injured last week in the Concordia game. And, of course, Peter Winklejohn, his backfield mate, is also out. So tonight for the starting lineup for the Saints, you're going to see, obviously, Pichelny, a quarterback. Effinger and Hake are getting the start, two seniors at running back. The receivers tonight are Tommy Steele, Bradley Black, and Nick Houck. And the big boys up front starts with sophomore Joe Tipman, Mitch Campbell, Frank Yanko, this fine center, Sam Henry, Marcos Olivas, and that will round out your starting offense for the Saints.
Starting for the defense tonight for the Bishop Luers Knights, Anton Berry, number 87, DJ Harris at defensive end, Jimmy Sturm, Trey Underwood lines up your front four right there. Gareth Brower gets a start as your nickelback. Your linebacker core, Dom Easley, Chance Richard, and Contrez Jordan is your strong safety. Your free safety is Deshaun Bussell. Your two corners tonight, Justin Gaston, number one, the sophomore, and C.J. Edwards, number 20. So, again, this is your starting lineups for tonight's contest as Peyton Howe, number eight, gets ready to kick this one away, kicking left to right on your radio dial. The ball is at the 40-yard line. Back to receive are Effinger and Hake for the Saints. And we are ready to go.
The Battle of the Bishops. Doesn't get any better than this.
Very interesting storyline for young Peyton Howe here. His family has a very, very vested interest in this outcome here, and it all starts with the two granddads, and we'll talk a little bit more about that a little bit later. Here is Peyton Howe's kick. It is a low liner taken by an up back near the 20, running forward, 25-30. He breaks the seam right through the middle. He's got a man to beat, stiff arm. He's still on his feet into Luers territory, down at the 40-yard line. And that is number 82, Watercutter, on a return for the Saints.
Nice up back, just took it, no hesitation, and took it right up the middle. Nice hole there opened up by the blocking crew on that kickoff return team.
Special teams could be a very big factor tonight, Joe, on the outcome for the contest here, as both squads really need to fire on all cylinders.
Great opening field position for the Saints, starting on the Luers 39, my goodness.
Here comes Pichelny and company on offense for the Saints, wearing the gold pants and helmets and the white jerseys with the navy numerals. They break huddle and come to the line. Single setback. Pichelny's going to be under center this time. Two wing backs, two wideouts. Now a man in motion going across the field to the right side. Here's a snap. Option play. Pichelny decides a late pitch. He's got it. The man gets to the corner. Gets run out of bounds before he's down.
Talked to the offensive coordinator this week, Jason Garrett. He wanted to give some different looks from under center.
Yep.
Felt like they were getting too predictable under center. So usually it's a dive play, something between the tackles. There we saw an option with Pichelny coming out from under center.
That was Mike Hake, number 32, the senior running back, gaining five down to the 34-yard line of Bishop Luers. Again, as Joe mentioned, excellent field position starting out for the Saints. Second and five in Luers territory at the 34. Same formation, two wing backs, two tight split ends. Now man in motion across the line. They give it to him. End around here on the left side. Looking for some room. Hits in the backfield. Nothing there. Tackle for loss.
Late flag comes flying in from the white hat, Sean.
Jordan Hudson, number 23, on the carry that time. That's
face
going
mask.
To be a face mask against Bishop Luers. An early penalty, their first one on the day for the Knights. And that is going to be the five-yard variety. So the tackle for loss is erased. He was stopped at the 36. And now with the penalty, they get down to the 31-yard line. So that brings up second and two for the Saints, needing to get down to the 29. Pichelny alone in the backfield, trips right to the left from the shotgun. Here's the snap. He's looking to throw on second and short, going deep. Right side, he's got a man. It's up and knocked away that time as Gilly on protection out there, number three.
Yeah, a little underthrown to Houck, the 6'2 receiver for the Saints. Gilly doing a nice job making up ground there and swatted the ball away. Big third down coming up for the Saints. Third and two, but it's two down territory here.
Oh, you bet. Absolutely. Already at the Luers 31-yard line. Houck checking out and Watercutter checking in for the Saints.
We have to mention, too, the Knights are without Deshaun Bussell tonight, the two-way starter, receiver, and safety. He is out in a walking boot there tonight.
Pro set this time for the Saints on third and two. Pichelny in the shotgun. Snap. Here's a little cross to the left side. Breaking through and getting the first down is number 32 on the carry, Mike Hake. And they move the chains.
Nice little counter there. That's something we have not seen yet this year. On the stop was Jimmy Sturm, number 99. He's a senior defensive end. They call him an outside linebacker. 6'3", nearly 250 pounds.
So the Saints on their first third down conversion are successful. They get down to the 27-yard line. Offense on the field here. Again, they widen out the formation here. Pichelny alone in the backfield with a wing back. Quarterback keeper right side. He puts his shoulder into it. He's going to have a nice run. Be stopped down near the 20-yard line. So very close. It looks like a 7-yard gain maybe.
Brower on the stop for the Knights. It is a nice pickup. Nice little quarterback keeper off the right side. Good blocking over there to seal that end. And finally, Brower is able to come over and get Pichelny to the ground.
So a second and very long three here for the Saints. We'll call it actually a gain of six, bringing up second and four. Put the ball at the 21. Yeah, it looks like a wildcat formation here for the Saints. Here is the snap. Running right through the middle, putting his shoulder into it is number 33, Mitch Effinger. And it looks like he will have enough for a first down.
Dominic Easley on the stop there.
Let's check in with the Godfather.
Well, hey, down here on the sidelines, I'm getting the feeling that there's a little bit of Momo developing for these gold helmets. The Knights look like they're catching rather than delivering on defense.
Yep.
So when they're coming to meet a guy, he's gaining an extra 2 yards or so.
Yeah, good call. So they're inside the red zone, first and 10 now for the Saints from the 17-yard line. Wildcat to the left this time. Direct snap, looking for some room, trying to find it. He will not. Great pursuit that time by the Bishop Luers defense to tackle Mitch Effinger in the backfield.
Justin Gaston, the sophomore there. Effinger needed to cut that up the middle. There was Holder. You and I both saw it.
Yep.
And he wanted to bounce it out. If he just held true and just hesitated a second, that hole opened up nicely for him.
So no gain on the play for the Saints. That brings up second and 10. As again, number 23, Jordan Hudson checking in for the Saints. Pichelny barking out the order. And here they come to the line. It's going to be a single setback, pistol formation, two wideouts to the right side, two left. Pichelny in the shotgun. Here's the snap. He looks to throw, looks right, throws to the flats. He's got his man. That's Houck. Gets to the side, gets dragged out of bounds near the 10-yard line.
In coverage is Chris Edwards, Jr. on the far sideline. Nice pitch and catch there. Pichelny to Houck on the little out route.
Yeah.
And talking to the coaches for the Saints, they feel like Pichelny really throws that out route nicely. Mm-hmm. They love to give him some of those. And then, you know, later on that will set up the up and out.
Yeah, that's
out
exactly
the up,
right.
Maybe
a double route, double move there. Game of seven that time. Brings up a third and three. just inside the 10-yard line for the Saints. Here's Pichelny, quarterback keeper, right side, looking, driving, finally gets pushed back. Let's see what forward progress gives him here. It may be enough for a first and goal coming up for the Saints. Let's see where they mark it on the far side of the field. Tough to see from here. They call a timeout, and they're going to measure, I believe.
What's the Godfather think?
Let's get the first call down here.
No, I'll just say, I think that's like the third time out of five that Pichelny has run the ball. I think those Knights need to fill that hole like they mean it. I'm going to lose my mind down here.
but is it a first down, Godfather?
Well, I'm not an official. Let them measure, and they'll tell you.
It is.
All right, they just did it. The white hat says first down. So first and goal coming up for the Saints. And let's see, I think they're going to mark this. But it's really tough from here to get a sideline. The lights are on and the lighting. Again, we've got breaking clouds here. No rain out here at Bishop Luers Field. And I think they're going to mark this at the 7-yard line. First and goal for the Saints. High formation now. Wide out to the right and left. Pichelny under center. Give to the tailback. Left side into the scrum. Big push. Nice job sealing that hole from the Bishop Luers Knights defense. As again, Dom Easley comes up from the bottom of the pile.
Yeah, nice job by Dom Easley for sure. There's that blast play right up the middle that the Saints love when that fullback's in there. So the Saints are just trying to play a little power football. Remember last week the Saints tried to play power football. The last play before half and got stuffed. Just trying to set up that dominance early here in the trenches.
Call that a gain of one, bringing up a second and goal now from the 6. Now they spread things out. Twins right and left and a single setback. Offset to the left. Now a man in motion coming to the left. Here's a snap. Option. Here's the pitch. He's got the pitch at the back, and it is strung out and stopped for no gain. Godfather, what'd you see? It ended up right there.
Well, I saw my first real collision of the night with Jalen Charlton coming up and really laying a nice tackle. Kept his legs and drove him. I like that kind of stuff. But I wanted to say, boy, these Saints are very impressive with this drive. They're chewing this clock up. We're about halfway through the first period, and the Knights haven't seen the ball yet.
Yeah, great point. You're absolutely right. So we call that a no gain on the play. It brings up third and goal just outside the 7-yard line. Working from the left hash mark are the Saints. Single setback, offset to the right with trips to the right. Pichelny in the shotgun flows to the right now. Looking to throw. Guns it. Caught. Touchdown.
Tommy Steele is the leading receiver on this team, Sean. He came in with 4 touchdown receptions. Give him 5 right here on that first drive.
Again, he flowed to the right end of the flats. He was wide open, and a good throw from Pichelny on the run, and 6 points on the board for the Saints.
Saints did a little crossing route over there. Gave the Knights a little bit of what Concordia gave the Saints last week. Those little crossing routes get those DBs crossed up. A wide open Tommy Steele.
For the Saints, C.J. Booth in to chip in the extra point or point after attempt here. Hauk on the hold. Here's a snap. Hold is good. Kick is up. And it is good. 7-0 here in the first quarter. 6:20 remaining. Saints on top of the Bishop Luers Knights. We're going to go ahead and step out for a 30-second break. This is the Bishop's Bowl here on Redeemer Radio, 106.3 FM.
Are you looking for an orthopedic specialist? Ortho Northeast has been serving the community for over 50 years with offices in 3 convenient locations. Look for the location nearest you. Dr. John Pritchard is a board-certified orthopedic surgeon with 20 years of experience with OME and can assist you with the best treatment plan for your knee or shoulder pain. Dr. John Pritchard is looking forward to meeting you and helping with all orthopedic needs. Call Dr. Pritchard at 260-484-8551 or visit the web at www.orthone.com.
We are back to live action here at Luers Field for the Battle of the Bishops, where the Bishop Dwenger Saints on top of the Luers Knights now, 7-0. First quarter action, 6:20 remaining. Saints started that drive in very good field position off of a nice kick return and were able to convert on their first drive. And now C.J. Booth prepares to kick the ball away for the Saints. Back deep is Hambright in the middle for the Bishop Luers Knights. He's standing at about his own 10-yard line. Wet track out there tonight, but the rain is holding off right now. And here is a squib kick through the middle, and it is touched up. No return that time by the up back. That's Gilly near the 33-yard line. Godfather, what do you have?
Well, again, I just want to say how impressed I was with that drive by the Saints. Just jab, 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 use the clock, and finally get in the end zone. Now we see what Coach Lindsay was talking about in our tailgate talk about run and pass schemes. See how he responds.
Aaron Nieves, a senior quarterback, gets the start tonight with a pro set behind him. Two wideouts on the short side, one wide left. Number five in the shotgun. Here is the snap. Quick give to Jalen Charlton. Flowing to the left side, looking for a seam. Finding a seam, getting into the linebacker core and running for close to 8 yards that time on the first carry from scrimmage is Jalen Charlton.
Riley Miller came on the blitz, but he came the wrong side. Nice play call there at the right time for the Knights. The starting defense for the Saints tonight. Up front, you have Luther Hall, Steven Nix, Yanko, and Henry. Linebackers getting the call tonight are Miller, Hake, and Bloom. And in the defensive backfield, you have Effinger, Watercutter, Steele, and Obergfell.
So here come the Bishop Luers Knights on second and two now. Here's a snap as Nieves looks to throw. He's got all kinds of time in the backfield. Finally, the pressure comes, and he grounds the ball right through the middle.
Nothing there. Nice coverage in the defensive backfield by those four we just called. Let's say their name again. Effinger, Watercutter, Steele, and Obergfell.
Really doesn't give Nieves much of a chance on that one. So they burn it down on the incompletion and brings up third and a long two. Ball resting at the 42-yard line of Bishop Luers.
Last week, the Saints defense struggled to get off the field against Concordia. Concordia was 5 of 8 on third down conversions. Let's see if the Saints can get off on a good foot tonight.
Nieves in the shotgun with split backs, two wide outs to the right, one wide left. Saints back off coverage, and here's a sweep. This time, Hambright comes around the side. He's got the first down, breaking tackles, gets across the midfield stripe, but there is a flag on the play. Back near the 40-yard line.
I think we're going to get a hold, and that's exactly what we're going to get as a hold against the Knights. Steven Nix, the defensive end, was trying to get to the sideline, and he was getting held up by one of the Knights. Second penalty against the Knights tonight. They had a 5-yard early and then 5-yard face mask early and then this 10-yard holding call.
So the first down is nullified. And they move the ball back to the 30-yard line for the Knights. And now that brings up third and about 14 now for the men in black. Nieves comes in from the sidelines after talking to Coach Lindsay. And breaks huddle with about 10 seconds remaining on the play clock. Again, split black backs, two wideouts to the left side, one wide right. Here's a snap. He's looking to throw. Blitz coming. It is picked up. He has to tuck it. Oh, now he's got trouble. He's got pressure. Throws the ball, and it is going to be an incomplete pass.
There's a flag.
Yep, he was in the grasp, and they're going to call that intentional grounding.
Intentional grounding. Isaac Bloom providing pressure. When we talked to Coach Schwarzkopf this week, Isaac Bloom is one name he mentioned as a kid who has had a couple great games.
Yeah, very high on Isaac Bloom's performance, and it shows right there. So let's see what happens here. Now, he had pressure and was taken.
Yeah, it'll be a loss of down.
Yeah, near the 30-yard line. So that is where they're going to mark it with the loss of down. Oh, they're going to step it back.
Yep. 5 yards from the point plus a loss of down. So that's a punting situation for sure.
In fact, so the first drive from scrimmage kind of disintegrates for the Bishop Luers Knights as the ball is now resting at their own 15-yard line. Fourth and forever, Peyton Howe will launch this one from inside his own five. The Saints now looking if, in fact, the kick is away. Fine kick. It's going to be caught near the midfield stripe. Watercutter again with the ball, looking for some room. Puts his shoulder into the hit. Gets driven out of bounds near the 46-yard line. So maybe a 4-yard return that time for Watercutter. And again now, Joe, the Saints set up with great field position inside Luers territory.
Sean, this is the second drive of the game for the Saints, and it's the second drive of the game for the Saints that starts inside Knights territory.
Yeah.
You're exactly right. The Saints are obviously winning the field position battle here early.
7-0 is your score. Saints on top. This is their second drive. 4:46 remaining in the first quarter, and the Saints now break huddle and come to the line. Pichone, the quarterback, he'll be under center this time with a single setback. Two wideouts left and right. Looks over the defense. Here is a snap. gives to the man going right through the middle. Another blast play. 33 is the carrier, Mitch Effinger, getting the workout tonight so far early and getting a nice push. Call that a gain of about four down to the 42-yard line.
Yeah, hit at the line of scrimmage, but you know what? Effinger runs low, shoulder square, falling forward, hits easily, easily makes a stop, but easily gets pushed forward for a couple extra bonus yards by Effinger.
Second and six now for the Saints. Two wing backs, two wide outs to the right side, one left. Hake now in motion behind the quarterback. Now give to Hake through the middle. Bounces that out to the right side. Won't find anything there. Great job by that Bishop Luers defense to close up those holes.
Anton Berry, 6'6", 213 pounds of Anton Berry, met Mr. Hake on the far side there.
Had an opportunity to talk to Anton during tailgate talk tonight. Great kid. Represents himself and the school very well. Senior night tonight here at Bishop Luers as well. So he's having a great night so far.
No doubt about it.
Really no gain on the play, maybe 6 inches at the most. We'll still call it a third and six situation for the Saints. Ball at the Luers 42-yard line. I formation now for the Saints. Under center is Piccioni. Here's a snap, rolls to his right, looks to throw, going deep. He's got a man. He's got room. It is caught in stride.
Tommy Steele again.
Touchdown, Saints. A 42-yard throw from Piccioni to Tommy Steele, and Jaws comes up with another touchdown
wow.
for the Saints.
Tommy Steele, listen, we saw last week Piccioni make some nice deep balls, and a couple of them got dropped, actually. Tommy Steele was not going to drop that one. He had separated from the defensive back, and it was absolutely on the money. Piccioni to Steele, good combo here tonight.
So another 6 points on the board for the Gold Helmets, and let's see if, in fact, C.J. Booth can make it seven. Hauk on the hold. It's a good snap. The kick is up. It looks good from here, and it is. 14-0 is your score with 3 minutes and 13 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Stick around, folks. We're back after this 30-second break. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio 106.3 FM.
Hello, sports fans. This is Father Bob Garrow, chaplain at Bishop Dwenger High School. It is time to get geared up for our fall sports season. Whether competing on the soccer field, golf or cross-country course, volleyball court, or on the gridiron, we wish good luck and great sportsmanship to all our student athletes and their teams. May we become the Saints we are called to be. Saint Sebastian, pray for us.
14-0 is your score. The Bishop Dwenger Saints over the Bishop Luers Knights here in first quarter action. Bishop's Bowl 2016. As again, Piccioni to Steele on a 42-yard hookup there. Puts seven more points on the board for the Saints. And here comes C.J. Booth to kick this one away from the 40. His first kickoff was a low ship kick. And this one is again on the ground, taken near the 25.
He dropped
the ball
it.
Is still on the ground. Gaston that time having trouble picking up that ball. Finally do cover it. And Bishop Luers will start off first and 10. From about their own 27-yard line.
Jared Lee on the special team stop for Bishop Dwenger.
Nieves coming back in for the second series here for the Bishop Luers Knights. Again, in the last two games, this is his first game back from injury here. Norman Kanapke had stepped in for the last two games and done a fine job. Nieves from the shotgun here. Here's a quick give to Jalen Charlton on the counter through the middle. He's in the linebacker
core.
Here he goes. Down the right side, the 50, the 40. Getting knocked out of bounds near the 30-yard line of Bishop Luers by number 33. That is Hake. Or check that, Effinger on the stop for the Saints. Jalen Charlton, there's that speed on display,
he
Joe.
Is special. He's 6'3", 200 pounds. He runs like Eric Dickerson. And right there, he was very patient, waited for that hole to open up in the middle, and then boom. He was gone. And, you know, you don't have that Winklejohn in the middle filling some of these holes.
Yep.
Jalen Charlton comes into this game averaging 12 yards per carry.
42-yard run that time by, check that. We're going to get a yardage update on that run. Takes it into Bishop Dwenger territory. First and 10 at the 31. Here's a quick counter. This time Hambright, right side. He's got some room. Getting very patient and getting down to the 3-yard line. Tyrion Hambright, the other tailback, he's just as dangerous.
Wow, and he runs hard. He runs. Yes. That young man averages 7.5 yards a carry. Great block by Trey Underwood, 52.
That's exactly right.
He pulled to lead the play, and, man, did he lead the play. He delivered a blow out there to a defensive end for the Saints. And now the Knights are trying to make a statement here, getting physical
That's
with
exactly
the Saints.
Right.
I love this.
10-yard run that time. Takes it down to the 31-yard line. 21-yard run that time by Charlton, followed up by a 10-yard run by Hambright. And the Bishop Luers Knights are knocking at the door right outside the red zone at the 21-yard line. Split backs this time. Two wideouts to the left, one wide right. From the shotgun, Nieves gives to Charlton.
Heck yeah,
he's got room in the backfield. He is smothered and stopped. 57 that time, getting a fine break on that play for the Saints, Joe.
Steven Nix and, of course, Hoss Henry, all 280 pounds of Hoss Henry, number 78, hitting Jalen Charlton. And, you know, you said, well, they give it back to Charlton, and I'm thinking, absolutely
yes,
they
darn
do.
Darn right.
Keep feeding him. Just feed him.
Small loss on the play brings up second and 10.5 for the Knights. As Nieves makes his way back into the huddle. And here they come up to the line. 14-0 is your score. Saints on top so far, first quarter action. Split back, same formation there, two wideouts to the left side. Nieves rolls to his left, looking to throw. He's got backside pressure. Yanko's coming. He gets hit, throws the ball, incomplete pass.
He got hit his right. Frankie Yanko and Luther Hall met together at Nieves. Nieves bounces right up. Good for him. He has a big brace or a big pad or something on that left leg. Remember, he went down week two late in that game with a leg injury. This is his first action since week two.
So it brings up a challenge here. Third and 10.5 now for the Knights. Again, ball in between the 21 and 22-yard line of the Saints. So really not able to break into the red zone yet.
Absolutely, you got to be two down territory.
Well,
here,
they're
Sean.
Down by
I mean,
two
that's,
scores.
That's
you're,
obvious.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. So let's see what they do here on third and 10.5. Same formation, split backs, two wideouts to the left. Nieves gives to Charlton, bounces it out to the left side. He is fast. They stretch it out. He gets to the sideline. He gets hit. It will not be enough for a first down. But Charlton again with those wheels.
Yeah, he used every bit of it. It was on the close hash mark here to us. He went all the way to the far sideline before he was able to turn it up and pick up about six.
That's right.
Before Mike Hake ran him out of bounds.
Brings up a fourth and four. The offense remaining on the field. They have broken into the red zone. Ball resting now near about the, what did you call that, Joe, the 16?
That's
maybe
what I'd call it.
16-yard line, yeah.
Clock running down. Nieves just gets back to the huddle. 10 on the play clock as they hustle to the line.
He did get out of bounds. That stops the clock at 1:51 to go here in the first quarter. On fourth and four, and now a timeout on the field called by Bishop Luers.
Yeah, play clock was down to one. They had to. The timeout came from the sidelines, guys.
Well, again, as always, we want to try and keep you abreast of the situation from around the SAC, so we're going to see if, in fact, checking in with Nick Gray has us any positive results from early scores from around the area.
Well, things are underway, guys, out at Homestead. Carroll went up first, but then Homestead came back and scored, so that's 7-3, Homestead over Carroll. But right now, Snyder's beating Northrop 13-0. And the other game that I have is New Haven's beating Belmont 14-0. So we'll keep an eye on the action around the league tonight and bring those updates as we get them in. Back
up
to you guys.
Nick Gray, thanks very much. Just a reminder, folks, as Bishop Luers prepares for fourth and four, tomorrow night it's the Smoker
right here.
Bishop Luers. Mass starts at 5:45 with the festivities beginning at 7. If you have not gotten your tickets, don't worry. You can show up and buy them at the door. A great time. Boy, the hospitality, the feedback, the fun. It's all right here at Bishop Luers tomorrow night. Fourth and four for the Knights. Split backs, two wideouts to the right side. Here's a snap. Fake to Charlton. Play action. Looking to go left side. It's a touch pass. Nearly picked. And incomplete.
That's great coverage over there by Mike. No, that's Bloom.
Yeah.
The linebacker picks up a back out of the backfield, running down the sidelines, and did a great job running stride for stride and timing his jump perfectly to tip that ball away on fourth down. Saints hold. Saints hold.
That's exactly right. So, again, the offense, a little bit of a struggle here in the beginning of the contest for the Bishop Luers Knights as the Saints take over first and 10 now. at their own 15-yard line. They're up 14-0. Under 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Pacelny under center. Here is the snap. Give to the tailback. Running right through the middle. He finds room. Gets into the linebacker core. Going to be a nice gain of 7 or 8 that time.
Nice trap there. You had Henry pulling the big right guard, pulled and destroyed his guy and opened up a nice hole there for the back.
Yeah, Mike Hake on the carry that time.
I know it was an emphasis this week, Sean, for the coaches to do better on first and second down. Last week against Concordia, they had too many 3rd and 10, 3rd and 12. They had to get some positive yards on 1st and 2nd down.
That time they did. Call it a gain of 8, bringing up a 2nd and 2. Pacelny again under center. Right package this time. This time they go to the right. Falling forward near the 25-yard line. I don't know if he'll have enough for a first down. That is, again, Mike Hake on the carry.
There's the first down.
There it is. Okay, so he did get enough for a first down. They mark it 1st and 10 at the 25 now. Hake just enough for the first down for the Saints as Pacelny comes in from the sidelines. After talking to offensive coordinator Jason Garrett. Under a minute to go here in the first quarter. Saints with a trips package to the right, 2 to the left, empty backfield, Pacelny in the shotgun. Here's a snap, looks left, throws to the flats, he's got him. That's Hake with the catch, has enough for a first down, close to the 40-yard line.
Gaston on the stop in coverage for the Knights.
And again, the Saints move the chains. Stops the clock with 30.4 seconds remaining. And they officially mark this ball at the 38-yard line.
Nice little route there, a little stop route for Hake. Just got to the open area, turned around, looked for the ball. And Pacelny delivered a strike.
1st and 10 for the Saints. Again, empty backfield, trips right. Here's a snap. Pacelny again looks left. Another quick hitch pass to Hake. Across the 40, forward progress out to about the 43-yard line.
Sean, if you saw right there what I saw, and I know you did because you got great eyes, Jordan, the defensive back, jumped that route. He got there right as the ball did. That's when you set up the go, the pump and go.
Right, yep.
When they're going to
exactly
jump it
right.
Like that, you set up the double move.
That'll do it for your first quarter, ladies and gentlemen. 14-0 is your score. Dwenger over Luers. Stick around. We're back after this one-minute break. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio, 106.3 FM.
Hello, I'm Tom Steele with Tom Steele Tire and Auto Repair, a family-owned business for over 35 years. We carry all major brands of new tires, as well as a large selection of quality used tires to save you money. We do all types of auto repairs, be it brakes, alignment, or just fix your air conditioning. Tom Steele Tire, North Clinton or Illinois Road. Give us a try. You'll be glad you did.
You can help support your Catholic parish or school with Notre Dame Federal Credit Union's Elevate program. You'll not only enjoy excellent personal service and save money with your new loan or credit card, you'll also be giving money back to the participating parish or school you care about. Let Notre Dame Federal Credit Union elevate all participating parishes or schools. Elevate can be reached at 844-230-6611 or visit us online at ndelevate.com. Independent from the university.
We are back to live action here, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Bishop's Bowl 2016. At the start of the second quarter, where the Bishop Dwenger Saints are on top of the Bishop Luers Knights 14-0.
False start on the Saints. Not the way to start second quarter. Their first penalty of this game. Real quick, Sean, I have some quarterback stats for that first quarter. Pacelny was 5 of 6 for 74 yards and 2 touchdowns, both to Tommy Steele. Nieves, the senior, getting the start here back tonight. 0 for 4 in the first quarter.
Alrighty. So penalty on Bishop Luers to start the second quarter. Their first of the night brings it to, instead of 2nd and 5, 2nd and 10 now. Got a little timeout here as they reset the clock. Pacelny will be in the shotgun. Again, that trips package to the right and 2 to the left. Offensive coordinator Jason Garrett really favoring this open backfield look here so far early tonight.
Have seen a lot of it.
Yeah. On 2nd and 10, Pacelny with the ball. Looks to throw.
There's a double move.
Double move.
There's a double move.
Deep left side. He's got two receivers and overthrew them both.
That, yeah. somebody ran a wrong route because there was two receivers for the Saints on the far sideline running by shoulder to shoulder down the sideline.
Right, yeah.
Somebody was supposed to do a different route. The double move, we knew it was coming.
Godfather, what do you have for us?
Well, hey, you know, during a football game, there's three kinds of people. People that make things happen, people that let things happen, and people that wonder what the heck happened. And I'll tell you right now, the Saints are making good things happen. Those guys were wide open. He just overthrew them. The Knights are letting things happen. If they don't hustle, they're going to find out. They're going to be the ones wondering what the heck happened at the end of this game.
Good call. From the pistol formation, single setback, trips right, one left on third and 10 for the Saints now. Here's a snap, blitz coming. Luers, he rolls to the right. He's got pressure, wings it down the field, nearly picked off, but incomplete.
He gets smacked there by Barry, number 87. Pichelny gets smacked as he throws it by Barry. Nearly an interception by Jalen Charlton.
So let's see here. That is the third possession for the Saints offense, and this one is going to stall, and the punt team is on.
And that was the first third down conversion the Saints did not convert tonight. They were 4-for-4 on third downs before that one right there.
Again, 14-0 is your score. Bishop Dwenger on top. And let's see here. Okay, so they push the clock, and we're ready to go on fourth and 10. Pichelny, again, back to kick. Good snap. Kick is away. And it looks like Gaston will have his hand at it, and he does call a fair catch near the 27-yard line. So that is where Bishop Luers will take over. Folks, just a reminder that Holy Cross College is proud to bring you tonight's game. Holy Cross College is an affordable Catholic college offering a life-changing, life-affirming education, and is closer than you think. Just 2 hours away up north, you can search for them on the web at Holy Cross College at Notre Dame.
Here come the Knights. Nieve is still the quarterback for the Knights. Again, 0-for-4 in that first quarter, getting his first action here since week two. Let's see if the Knights can get something going offensively, Sean.
So here's our first drive in the second quarter. Here's a give to Tyron Hambright around the right side. Gets into the linebacker core. Good pursuit angle that time, but good positive yards as well for Hambright. He just runs angry, Joe.
He runs so hard, and he took the perfect angle on that run.
Yeah.
I mean, he was coming right at us. He just did it perfectly. And Mike Hake finally was able to get over there from his linebacker spot and make a play.
Gets it out to the 33-yard line. Brings up a second and short four or five. Call it second and four coming up for the Knights as they break huddle and come to the line. Again, single setback. Double tights, one wide out left and right. Here's a snap, give to Hambright again, trying the way of the right side. This time he is hit in the middle and driven back. Again, first contact that time was by Mike Hake.
Mike Hake again all over the field, but there's that double whistle drill the Godfather always talks about.
Yes.
There was 11 gold helmets flying to the point of impact. And as a former coach, we all love to see that.
Darn right. Positive gain out to the 35-yard line. Gain of two brings up a third and two now for the Knights. As Charlton checks in, and here comes Nieves from the sidelines. Breaks huddle with about 11 seconds to go on the play clock. Critical third and two for the Knights. Split backs. Wide out to the left side. Here's a snap, and it's a throw out to the right side. It's a give to Hambright. Call it a pitch. And will he have enough for a first down? It looks like it as he gets close to the 40-yard line.
Needed two, picked up about three. Isaac Bloom on the stop for Bishop Dwenger.
They do give him a first down, and they mark it at the 39-yard line. So a fresh set of downs now for the Knights.
This is my first time to see Hambright play. I've heard you guys talk about this young man and how hard he runs, and you see it.
Yeah.
Those legs are just churning. He really is powerful.
Yeah, dual threat in the backfield there for the Knights with Jalen Charlton and Tyrion Hambright. Brower also doing a fine job in the backfield for the Knights as well. First and 10, here they are. Play action. He's got trouble. He steps out of it, steps to the right, looking to make something happen, and he does not. It's finally Arian Nieves gets sacked. Tackle for loss that time. Huge pressure up front by number 59, Joe.
Frankie Yanko flushed Nieves right out of the pocket, and Steven Nix is over there to clean up and get a sack. Or not even a sack, no gain. Let's call it no gain.
Call it no gain. Brings up a second and 10 for the Knights. This is second quarter action. 9:15 to go in the quarter. 14-0 is your score. Bishop Dwenger on top of the Knights. Knights moving right to left on your radio dial. Now facing a second and 10 from their own 39-yard line as Gilly checks in for the Knights.
The Saints, that last play on first down, were in a five-man front anticipating another run.
And now we've got a whistle-blown play is called dead. And another timeout for the Bishop Luers Knights. That's their second here in the first half. Gives us an opportunity to step out as well. 14-0 is your score. Saints on top. Stick around, folks. SAC football right here on Redeemer Radio 106.3 FM.
Shawnee Construction and Engineering is proud to support tonight's game. We specialize in commercial and industrial construction and use unique life cycle principles to provide our clients the highest quality craftsmanship for the life of the project. Shawnee Construction and Engineering are partners with you for lifetime savings. We can be found at ShawneeConstruction.com or at 260-489-1234. That's 260-489-1234.
And we are back to live action here, ladies and gentlemen. Timeout is over for Bishop Luers, and both teams come back to the line as Bishop Luers is facing a second and 10 after burning their second timeout in the first half here. Split backs, two wideouts to the right side, Nieves from the shotgun. Here's a quick give with the left side, finding some room is Brower. Gets into the linebacker core, stretches for that first down marker. Will not have enough, but be very close and give them a third and short coming up.
Nice hard run inside between the tackles there by Brower.
Godfather, what are you seeing down there? What's the vibe?
Well, the vibe I'm feeling is last week in their 685-yard offensive performance, they strapped the saddle on Charlton and Hambright. I think they need to do that again tonight until it gets shut down. That'll open the pass up for them.
All right, let's see what happens here on third and two for the Knights. Pro set, Nieves from the shotgun. Here's a snap. Give to Hambright. No, option, left side. Here's a pitch. Brower has it. He gets to the sidelines. Gets knocked out of bounds. He will have enough as he gets across the midfield stripe into Dwenger territory.
The Knights optioned on the short side of the field here, Sean, because of where the safety water cutter had lined up on the other side of the field. That makes it hard to cover the pitch man.
Right.
Puts a lot of pressure on the corner, which is Bradley Black. And you see it was a good play to pick up positive yards and a first down.
First and 10 for the Knights in Dwenger territory now at the 49-yard line. Same pro set for Bishop Luers. Play action, rolling to his left, looking to throw. He throws across the middle.
Pick. Interception.
Intercepted that time. Going down low was number 39 for the Bishop Dwenger Saints and picking it up off the carpet.
Isaac Bloom picks up his first interception of this season and the fifth for the Bishop Dwenger defense. Nieves still has not completed a pass to a Bishop Luers Knight.
Well, and that's really, really tough for the Bishop Luers Knights because they were really putting together a nice drive, eating up a lot of time on that clock to start this second quarter. And that kills it right there.
Well, Nieves double pumped. He clutched once, and it gave the defenders an idea where he was going to go with it. And Bloom read the eyes and went to the point.
So here's the Saints on offense, led by Pichelny. He's under center, wing to the right side. And here is a reverse pass. They give it to Jaws, going to the left side. Steele has it, trying to find some room around the edge on the far side. Does find the edge, cuts it up, gets it close to the 50-yard line.
I like the play, a little reverse. After a turnover, you really try to catch those ends on the far side sleeping. Sturm stayed home, and he just got outran to the sideline by Steele.
Gain of seven that time by the Saints. And they're going to mark this down at the 48-yard line. Second quarter action with 7:50 to go here in the first half. 14-0 is your score. Saints on top. Saints moving left to right on your radio dial. Pichelny alone in the backfield, trips to the right, two wide left from the shotgun. Here is the snap. He looks left, fires, hitch pattern, and it is caught. Flats left side. And again, a nice throw and pitch that time to Mitch Effinger, who catches the ball for a Saints first down across the midfield stripe into Luers territory.
Easley and Gaston on the stop for the Knights. These DBs for Luers are really biting hard on these hitches. Again, we have not seen our last double move by these Saints.
No, I agree. You're absolutely right. First and 10 at the Luers 45 for the Saints. Single setback now. Pichelny in the shotgun. They give it right through the middle, and not much there. He hits a wall. Does Mitch Effinger.
Hey, guys.
Godfather, what do you have for us?
No, I'll tell you, they're biting on the the Knights are biting on hitches. And I want to say, I think it's because these Saints are executing. I just get a feeling they're playing with a purpose tonight. They really are playing as a unit, and they're hustling everywhere they're going. The Knights just don't seem to have that giddy up. But let's see if it doesn't change.
Second and 10 coming up for the Saints now.
Dom Easley, again, the middle linebacker on that stop on the last play for Bishop Dwenger.
Trips package to the right, two left, empty backfield. Seen it a lot tonight for the Saints. Piccioni alone in the backfield, throws it. Another hitch pattern, this time goes in and out of the hands of his intended receiver. That, again, was Effinger, who went low to get that ball. But good coverage by the Knights, too.
Great coverage over there by Gaston. We've called Gaston and Easley. I mean, is there anybody else playing defense tonight? We've called their
sure
name like every single play.
I know it. Well, Gaston has that pedigree, that speed on the field. We've seen his two older brothers come through this program. And Gaston, with the start out there, he's only a sophomore and could very well be the fastest man on the field. Third and 10 coming up for the Bishop Dwenger Saints from the Knights' 45-yard line. Here's the snap. Piccioni has pressure through the middle, gets out of it. Flag comes out, runs down the sideline, tries for that first down, won't have it. But I think this one's coming back.
I do, too. That's if the Knights elect to take the penalty. Remember, that was third and long. Jordan Contreras on the stop.
They're going to mark him out with a fourth and four, so it looks like a gain of six on the quarterback keeper that time. But
I think you back him up, Sean.
I think you back him up, too.
The flag was deep in the backfield.
Yep.
Okay, so it's 10 yards from the point of the foul. It's about a 15-yard penalty.
Yeah, they're going to say the penalty happened near the 50, so they're going to mark it back to the 40-yard line.
Wow.
Yeah, they need to get down to the 37 of the Bishop Luers Knights. So it's third and forever now for
25.
The Saints. Yeah, with 6:30 remaining in the first half. Critical, costly penalty there for the Saints. I believe that's their second on the night.
Second of the night.
Yep. So third and 25 now for the Saints. Maybe we see another double move here.
Well, he needs time to do that. He had no time to set up his feet that last play.
Again, they empty the backfield, trips to the right, two left. Here's a snap. He rolls to the right automatically, tries to find some time. He slips and goes down at the 35-yard line.
Tripped up there a little bit by Barry, I think. At least he was trying to get away from Barry. Barry will get credit for the sack. Again, blitz came, well-timed blitz by the Knights, and Piccioni had no opportunity to look downfield.
No. So they mark it at the 36-yard line, and the punt team is on for the Saints. So a couple stalls here on offense for both squads as Piccioni prepares to kick this one away. Good snap, great kick this time by Piccioni. Fair catch called for by Hambright near the 25. Well, folks, Redeemer Radio is proud to launch a brand new product here, Redeemer Radio Odysseys. This is a travel program put together recently by Redeemer Radio. Very excited to announce a new website, RedeemerRadio.com/travel. Go there and check things out. They have a domestic trip planned for the March of Life coming up. And then in the fall of 2018, a trip to the Holy Land. For any questions you have, please call the travel coordinator over at Redeemer Radio. Her name is Tina Schneider. She can be reached at 436-9598. On first and 10 from the 25 from Bishop Luers. Here's the ball. Here's a snap. Give through the middle, trying that counter, and not much there for the Bishop Luers Knights.
Hoss Henry on the ground with a hold of that hoof. You see him? It's like he was in the rodeo
that's
arena.
That's exactly right. He was hog-tying somebody there. I tell you what, small gain that time brings up a second and 9 for the Bishop Luers Knights. 5 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the first half. Saints up 14-0 here. Bishop's Bowl 2016 coming to you live from Bishop Luers High School. Arian Nieves, the senior quarterback, getting the start tonight and still in the contest, facing a second and 9 with split backs, two wideouts to the right side, one left. Press coverage now as they start to back off.
Counter
give to Jalen Charlton. Trying his way around the left side, very successful, gets out near the 39-yard line.
There was that counter tray that Luers loves to run and has so much success with. That's when they pull the right tackle and right guard, and they lead the play around the left side. And it's one of their bread and butter plays. It's one we always see out of Bishop Luers along with the screens.
And interestingly enough, typically they try to cut it and find that seam through the middle. This time he went around the edge and was very successful with it that time. Jalen Charlton was. First and 10 now from the 38-yard line. Same formation this time. Split backs. Again, a give to Hamp right through the middle. He's got some. That's Charlton, excuse me. Hits the hole very hard. Still churning. Gets close to a 10-yard gain that time. Jalen Charlton right up the gut.
Well, I tell you, this Luers team, they are out to prove a point. They said, we don't care that this Saints defense only gives up 2 yards per rushing attempt. We're going to run the ball right at them, and they're getting it done here tonight.
That's exactly right. Gain of 9 on the carry brings up a 2nd and 1. Playbook wide open now for the Knights. They mark it in between the 47 and 48-yard line. They break huddle with twins to the right, one left, and split back. Nieves in the shotgun. Here's a snap. Give to Tyrion Hambright around the right side. He dances through the line. He's into the linebacker core. Has a first down across midfield down to the 46-yard line.
Looks like Tommy Steele making a touchdown-saving tackle on the far side of the field.
I think you're right, Joe. You're absolutely right. Well, they do mark him at the 45 with forward progress. Fresh set of downs now for the Knights as this drive continues with 3:57 left to go in the first quarter.
I'm sure the Knights would love to eat up the rest of this clock and get a score here to end this half, Sean, because they will get the ball back, right?
Yeah, that's exactly right. Yep. Again, 14-0 is your score. Saints on top, but Knights driving now. Here's a snap on 1st and 10. Again, a give right through the middle. Jalen Charlton, a swarming Saints defense, though, stops them after the initial hit. Call that a gain of 4, brings up a 2nd and 6.
Steven Nix on the stop, solid 4 on first down. I think you're going to be happy with that, Sean.
Yeah, oh sure.
At some point, I would like to see the Saints go to more of a 5-man front. Obviously, Nieves has been off all night. He's 0 for 5 with 1 interception. Just really take away the run, make Nieves beat you through the air.
Sure. On 2nd and 6 now for the Knights. Twins to the left side.
Counter Trey.
Counter through the middle. Jalen Charlton trying to find some room. He does get positive yards, but gets wrapped up and dropped. He will be shy of the first down. And it looks like we've got a Saint on the ground.
Frankie Yanko on the stop, and I don't know who the Saint is on the ground. It looks like Luther Hall.
It's Luther, yeah, Scotty Hall's boy. And he is sitting up. And now he goes back down for a rest. We're going to go ahead and step out for a little 30-second break here while they attend to Luther Hall. 14-0 is your score. Saints on top. Stick around, folks. We're back in 30 seconds. You're listening to Redeemer Radio, 106.3 FM.
Hey, sports fans. Listen to who just scored again. John Sullivan with Remax. Buying a home or selling yours? You need the best coach around. Score with John Sullivan at RE/MAX. Score with John. Call RE/MAX and ask for John Sullivan to coach you in buying a home or selling yours. Sports fans, it's time to score with John Sullivan at RE/MAX.
We are back to live action as Luther Hall makes his way off the field under his own power there. Bishop Luers facing a 3rd and 2 now.
Bart Tittman checks into the game at defensive end for Luther Hall.
Number 49 for the Saints. On 3rd and 2, here come the Knights. Here's a snap, and again, they give to Jalen Charlton, and we've got a flag coming out now. He falls forward for a first down near the 35-yard line, maybe the 34.
Looks like a hold, potentially.
Yeah, this one's coming back. You're absolutely right, Joe. Wow, that's a tough one right there. And it raises another first down for the Knights with 2:32 to go in the first half. Let's check in with the godfather of football, Dave X.
Oh, hey, you can't help but think, you know, you get a little nervous when you're starting in the battle of the bishops. I was a little nervous myself for the game. I was in that bathroom a few times. But I'll tell you what,
I bet.
14 quick points. And I'll tell you what, things have settled down. The Knights are on a drive, and I really feel like they need to score before the half.
No, you're absolutely right. Yeah, they've got a lot of momentum build up. It's taken quite a while, Godfather, but again, they've got to cap it. They've got to convert. 3rd and 11 now after the penalty. Saints defense backs off. Nieves going to the air again. He's got pressure up front. Yanko has pressure. The pocket collapses. He goes down for a sack.
Yanko again flushes Nieves out, and who's there but Steven Nix and Bart Tittman to get the sack. That Yanko is so disruptive.
Oh, he is, absolutely. He has dropped back at his own 48-yard line. Godfather, what'd you see?
Well, no, Yanko, he talked about it in tailgate, talking about him being a wrestler. He knows how to get rid of bodies. He knows how to get rid of a blocker. I just love watching him play.
I do, too. The buzzsaw.
That's right. Fourth and about 16 now, and the punt team is on. Peyton Howe. Oh, it's a low kick. Oh, right to him, though. Gets the kick off. It's a low liner. And it's bobbled a little bit, but then covered up by the Saint receiver. That is number 32, Mike Ake, able to protect that ball near the 24-yard line.
The Saints or the Knights got lucky on that snap, Sean. You called it. They pretty much one hopped back there, but it hopped right into the punter's hands. Fortunate for the Knights. Here come the Saints. See if they can get a two-minute drive going here with 1:41.
They're up 14-0 over the Knights, and Piccioni and company back on offense now. They've had better field position.
They've had a lot of opportunity to really work their passing game the last 2 weeks, Sean.
coming from behind
against Carroll. Yeah. So the passing game has been pretty good.
And it has. Single setback, wing to the right. Piccioni under center this time. First and 10 from their own 24-yard line. Here's a snap pitch, right side, looking for some room, breaking through. We've got a flag coming out. He gets into the linebacker court, shedding blockers, and finally taken down. Mitch Effinger with a nice hard-nosed run that time.
Holding against the Saints.
But this one's coming back again. So, again, a little sloppy play out there. The track is wet. The field, a natural grass field out here at Bishop Luers High School, makes things a little sloppy. We've seen it in the penalty department. Some holds coming against both squads.
It was a nice move by Hake, but you got to believe the hold set it up, Sean, because that's right where the flag was.
You're absolutely right. They put it back to the 13-yard line. So it did happen 1 yard in the backfield. And now the Saints are facing a first and 21.
First down, 21 yards to go first for the Saints.
So it's going to be very tough to pull off a two-minute drill here with 1:25 remaining in the first half with first and 21. Piccioni from the shotgun, looks to screen, looks right, guns it, and in and out of the hands of the crossing receiver. That time he was going for Steele, who's been a favorite target of his tonight, and they just couldn't make the connection.
You know, you have a new starting free safety back there, Sean, in number three, Gilly. Deshaun Bussell, again, is not playing tonight. He's the starting free safety. You have to believe we've seen a couple times Saints receivers are getting behind. They're getting behind the safety.
Yeah.
You got to wonder if they're going to take a shot here or they're going to just try to run out the clock.
Second and 21 now for the Saints with 1:18 remaining in the first half. Again, ball resting at their own 13-yard line. Under center is Piccioni with a single setback, trips to the left. And it's going to be a draw play through the middle, now bouncing it out to the left side. Is a running back. He gets into the linebacker core again. Nice hard-nosed run by Mitch Effinger.
And I think the Knights really need to get a timeout. Well, they're not going to call it now. They're going to wait and call it if the Saints don't convert.
He got some of that yardage back. It looks like about a third. Yeah, we'll call it third and 10 now. For the Saints up to the 23-yard line. Single setback, twins right and left for the Saints. Piccioni in the shotgun on third and 10. Here's a snap. Looks to throw. He has time. Guns it left side. Going down immediately is Effinger on the catch. I think he's going to be shy of the first down marker, close to the 35.
It is going to be real close.
Oh, let's see where they mark it. Godfather, what do you see down there?
No, but you got to take your hat off to the Piccioni and the Saints coaching staff. They watched film. They saw what Northrop was able to do with their passing game last week, and they're moving down the field. That receiver was right on the stick, so that's why it's a close one.
Well, I don't know what's going on now. They just signaled that the Saints took a timeout. Well, if he was short and it's fourth down, the Saints would not have wanted to
stop the clock. Yeah, and they are okay. Are they moving the chains? It looks like the chains are moving.
I think they believe they had it.
I think they gave him a first down.
That's why they call a timeout.
Okay.
Because initially the guy with the stick, he swished it to fourth down, and that's usually what we look at first.
No, exactly.
He's usually right there and on it.
Yep. So, again, that quick hitch to number 33, Mitch Effinger, does convert and give the Saints a fresh set of downs. First and 10 coming up with 30 seconds remaining in the first half. 14-0 is your score. Godfather, what do you have?
No, I just want to say again, Effinger going right to where he needed to be. That's smart football. I like that kind of play.
No, you're absolutely right.
Yeah, know where the chains are.
Yep, and get situational awareness. That's what that's called. All right, on first and 10 for the Saints. Waiting for the timeout to expire. Both teams at the line of scrimmage. The officials talk over a few things here first.
Saints still have two timeouts remaining in this half.
I think we've got an exciting halftime interview coming up with Nick Gray here for our halftime presentation, which is coming up right around the corner. And now Piccioni makes his way to the sidelines for a last-minute instruction with Coach Garrett. No whistle yet.
Not sure what is going on here. Oh, the white hat was over talking to the Dwenger coaching staff. He's hustling back. He's on his hustle horse.
Makes his way. The whistle blows. We are ready for action. First and 10 for the Saints. Empty backfield. Piccioni in the shotgun. Trips to the right. Here's a snap. Looks. Delayed blitz coming. Airs it out over the middle and floats it incomplete.
I'll tell you what. Kudos to the Knights coaching staff. They've watched film as well, Godfather. Yeah. And they keep blitzing where they need to blitz. They've seen that the line in certain areas has had trouble picking up blitzes in certain positions. And they're going right after that.
Yeah, great
and,
call.
And they're getting to Piccioni. He has no time to wait for his receivers downfield.
No. Go ahead, Godfather.
Hey, I just want to thank Joe. He's providing comedy. There's guys with earpieces on down here. Joe says, rest on his hustle horse. Four or five people started laughing down here.
I get that from you.
That's a Godfather original.
Yeah.
Yeah, second and 10 for the Saints here. Single setback. Piccioni on the quarterback draw. Breaks it out to the left side. Good call. He's got the first down as he scampers out of bounds. Past the 45-yard line with 19 seconds remaining.
They really need, the Saints really need at this point, if you're going to try to get a ball down to get in field goal range or at least a chance to get a touchdown here in this half, they need to go max protection. They need to leave a back end to help protect Piccioni because the Knights are blitzing and getting to him every time.
Yeah. You're absolutely right. Steele checks in for the Bishop Dwenger Saints. Again, a first and 10 from the 45-yard line. Piccioni in the shotgun, trips to the right, two wide left on the short side. Saints moving left to right on your radio dial. Here's a snap, looks to throw, he's got pressure, he flushed from the pocket, throws to the sidelines, A.J. Houck has it, Nick Houck, excuse me, catches the ball, gets out of bounds, past the midfield stripe, down to the 47 of the Knights.
Again, the Knights are committed to not letting Piccioni sit back there. They are bringing heat and flushing him. Nice job by the Knights.
So we'll call that a gain of 8 on the throw and catch. Piccioni to Houck. Steele checking out for the Saints. Brings up a second and 2 now into Knights territory at the 47. Let's see, we're going to have a pro set here with split backs, two wide outs to the left, one wide right on the short side. Here is a snap, looking left, throwing left, man coverage, Gaston in there to knock it away from Houck.
Yeah, bad decision by Houck. Gaston just sat there in a zone defense waiting for that. It was a zone defense, they're doing a two deep zone. Gaston's just sitting there in the zone waiting for that play. He was lucky that one was not picked.
You're absolutely right. Godfather, what do you have?
That's where you hear people say, you gotta pick that one.
Yeah
it was
pick
right
it
there.
And it's 6 points. I mean, you just gotta catch it.
Well, and again, they are alone out there, and I seriously doubt anyone can catch Gaston alone. So, yeah. Okay, so they burn that down on the incompletion. Brings up a 3rd and 2 for the Saints. Tight trips package on the short side, too wide to the left. Here's a snap, quarterback draw right through the middle. He's got the first down. And let's see, that may do it. They stop the clock with 5 seconds remaining. He gets it down to the 41-yard line. And another timeout by Bishop Dwenger. So we're going to go ahead and step out for a little 30-second break as well. 14-0 is your score in the waning moments of the first half. Saints on top of the Knights. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio 106.3 FM.
Diamonds are a girl's best friend, and diamonds are forever. And since 1988, Peter Franklin has been bringing you the finest diamonds imported from overseas diamond cutters. Peter Franklin Jewelers. Jewelry created from concept to completion by our master goldsmiths on staff. Peter Franklin Jewelers, with 3 locations to serve you. New Haven, DuPont Road, and Angola. Remember, it's not just jewelry, it's Peter Franklin.
We are back to live action here where the Bishop Dwenger Saints have called a timeout. They're facing a first and 10 on the Bishop Luers 42-yard line. Could be the last play of the first half here as they break huddle and come to the line. Check that 41-yard line of Bishop Luers. Twins package left and right for the Saints. Single setback. Pagelny in the shotgun. Here's a snap. Blitz comes. It is not picked up. He wings it. It's a throw and a prayer. Jump ball and nearly picked that time by Gaston as the time runs out on the first half. So that's going to do it, ladies and gentlemen. The Bishop Dwenger Saints lead the Bishop Luers Knights 14-0 as we're going to step out for a one-minute break. Stick around. Our halftime presentation is up right after this one-minute break. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio 106.3 FM.
Redeemer Radio gladly thanks Dr. Mark Stoner, a St. Jude parishioner, for underwriting a portion of our programming. Dr. Stoner offers comprehensive dentistry for every family member. Dr. Stoner can be found at 9830 Auburn Road. For more information regarding all your dental needs, it can be found on the web at markstonerdds.com or at 260-484-4181.
Tri-State Warehousing is one of the most complete service-oriented companies in the warehousing field today. Located in Fort Wayne, Tri-State Warehousing is a 50,000 square foot dry and temperature controlled storage facility serving two-thirds of the continental U.S. with overnight rail service. The dedicated staff and specialty services of Tri-State Warehousing are known throughout the industry. For great things in store, call Tri-State Warehousing, 260-436-2010. That's 260-436-2010.
We are back to live action here, ladies and gentlemen. It's halftime at the Bishop's Bowl 2016. The score is 14-0. Bishop Dwenger on top of the Bishop Luers Knights. And right now we're going to send it down to the sidelines with Nick Gray.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the sidelines. Very special evening here, the Battle of the Bishops. You know, historically I get to talk to some pretty special guys, namely the Bishop at the Bishop's Bowl. Over the years, I've had some great interviews with Bishop Darcy and then Bishop Rhodes here recently. They're not here tonight, so we're going to substitute and mix it up. So we got Father Bob Garrow here from St. Vincent's Parish, and also the chaplain of Bishop Dwenger High School. Welcome, Father Bob, once again.
Thank you, but it's actually St. Jude, not St. Vincent's.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I forgot. There's more than one parish.
There is.
Anyhow, we do have Father Jonathan Norton, who's a Bishop Luers graduate and out at St. Vincent's Parish. Welcome, Father Jonathan.
Thank you very much. It's always fun to come out for the Battle of the Bishops.
And filling in for the Bishop, we got David Hunick here tonight.
Yes, yes. I'm glad to be here. Glad to be here.
So David's a seminarian. What year are you?
Third theology. I'm on pastoral year at St. John the Baptist on Fairfield. So I'll be there until December.
So then you go back to school and then you'll be?
Ordained a deacon, God willing, in May. So.
God willing. But you are with Father Andrew, so that might be a little difficult.
At times. At times. I know he's listening, so I'll be nice.
Darn, I thought you would take that bait. So anyhow, Father Jonathan, I
stay here, dude. You should do some distance learning and just stay at St. John's. I know that'd be fun.
It'd be fun. So it's always great joy to have the priest down on the sidelines, whether it be at a Bishop Luers game or a Bishop Dwenger game. Kind of unique tonight because we have Father Jonathan Norton kind of decked out in Bishop Dwenger garb. How's it feel being back home on the Luers sidelines as a Dwenger supporter?
I didn't anticipate how much of a traitor I would feel like, except the fact that, you know, June 6th of last year, something very special happened. I became a father, and I have children that go to Bishop Dwenger, so, you know, I'm a father that has to support his kids, so I'm all Dwenger tonight, yeah.
Well, that's good. I know, you know, we can yuck it up, and we're pretty blessed here in Fort Wayne to have two great Catholic high schools serving our diocese and doing such a great job. And so you've got to be proud to be alumni of Bishop Luers.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, Bishop Luers was a great experience for me when I was a teenager, and teaching me to pray and teaching me about the faith. And I absolutely credit a lot of my vocation to being at Bishop Luers. And to be able to then go on to the other side and to help at Bishop Dwenger and hearing confessions and just being a part of that community, it is. It's both schools are very, very special, and we're very blessed in our diocese to have the Catholic high schools we do.
So earlier tonight, Father Bob was telling me a little bit about some you know, special speaking of special moments, the pregame mass out at Bishop Dwenger. So, and Father Jonathan actually joining you. So tell me a little bit about that and how that went.
Yeah, Bishop Dwenger, every game has a mass with the football team. And so Father Jonathan calls me up or texts me and says, hey, I'm not celebrating mass that day. Do you mind if I can celebrate? And I really had to think about it for a while. I'm like, I don't know, you're a Luers grad, but, you know, I don't know if I should have this. But then I, of course, text him back. He's a good guy and a good priest. And I said, yeah, but I'm the main celebrant, but you're going to preach. And so it was really good, a really exciting time. But, you know, really another exciting aspect was Coach Schwartzkopf. He reminded his team this year, right before this week, and he told me earlier in the year, and I reminded him right before this Luers week, always a big game. He said when he first got hired as the coach at Bishop Dwenger, Bishop Darcy called him into his office. And he's like, oh my gosh, what have I done? But then Bishop Darcy actually said, no, football's important. I want you to restore the rivalry between Dwenger and Luers. And of course, Coach Schwartzkopf wins the game that year as well. And so he reminded that, and he always remembered that though. But Bishop Darcy was like, I like football, but restore the rivalry. And he knew that two good teams, Luers and Dwenger, being competitive on the field is good for the Diocese of Fort Wayne, South Bend, and especially for the city of Fort Wayne.
Well, it draws great attention to both Catholic schools. And like I said earlier before, I had some great times on the sideline with Bishop Darcy. And he would either sit on one side first half, the other side the second half. But then later on in his career, he would just sit out there in the middle of the end zone. So it was kind of cool. I got a great picture of Father Jason Freiberger, the bishop, and I. So, you know, guys, thank you so much tonight for being out here, for representing the priesthood, for representing our schools, and for all that you do for Redeemer Radio, too. So really appreciate it. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, we've been pleased to be joined with Father Bob Garrow from St. Jude School and Bishop Dwenger High School, and then seminarian David Hunick from St. John's Fort Wayne, spent a little time here over at Luers, and then also Father Jonathan Norton spending time historically in the past at Bishop Luers, now a little bit at Dwenger. So thank you guys for being here. With that, back up to you, Sean.
All right, thanks very much, Nick Gray. All right, folks, we're going to go ahead and step out and do a little one-minute break. When we come back, we will have stats from Jose Lopez. Then we'll get a roundtable discussion with Corey Kitchen, Joe Wharton, the Godfather of Football, and myself, and talk about the first half, what we saw, and what's to come in the second half. Stick around, folks. 14-0 is your halftime score here at the Battle of the Bishops 2016. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio, 106.3 FM.
Illumination Solutions is a family-owned and operated business that specializes in LED low-voltage landscapes and holiday lighting for homes and businesses. And now we introduce our new business called The Mosquito Doctor that specializes in mosquito barrier and event spraying. In addition, mosquito misting systems are also available. The phone number is the same for both businesses at 260-489-1000.
Think of Briscoe Dentistry for your family's dental care. Dr. Todd Briscoe and team know that your body is more than just teeth and gums. Your oral health affects the performance ability of your entire body. And on the field or court, you want your body to perform at its best. So trust Dr. Briscoe and team to provide the ultimate in preventative, periodontal, orthodontic, restorative, and cosmetic dentistry. To optimize your body's performance, contact Dr. Briscoe at 260-486-9950 or on the web at briscoedentistry.com.
Football fans. And just a reminder that Hubcap Express is the expert in run flat tires and plus size fitment. You need your tires aligned and straightened? Hubcap Express fixes bent rims for all your tire needs. Visit Hubcap Express, located at 606 West Coliseum Boulevard, or on the web at hubcapexpress.com. All right, let's go back down to the sidelines with Nick Gray, who's got some updates from around the area.
Well, you're really making me work tonight, Sean, but happy to do it. We thought the Carroll at Homestead game was going to be a little tighter, but right now Homestead has opened that one up wide, 21-3. That's just heading into halftime.
Wow.
Snyder's beaten Northrop 30-0. And then Southside at Northside. So the totem pole bowl, right, guys?
That's it.
Southside is leading that one 7-6. And there is an actual totem pole. I saw a picture of it on Twitter tonight.
Okay.
So Concordia, I think it's homecoming over at Concordia. They're beating Wayne 27-0, which is kind of a shocker to me. New Haven's up on Belmont 21-3. East Noble's beating Columbia City 20-0. DeKalb's beating Northrop 17-0. And then Leo is up on Huntington North 21-3. So that's where we're at. Back up to you guys.
All right, Nick. Thank you very much for that update. Let's get quickly over to Joe Wharton. I believe Joe is prepared for the first half stats. Joe, are you with us?
Yeah, let's talk first about the visiting Bishop Dwenger Saints. Total offense in the first half for the Saints, 141 yards. Pichelny, 8 of 16, 99 yards, 2 touchdowns. Rushing, Hake had 6 carries for 19 yards. Effinger, 6 carries for 18 yards. Dwenger, 42 total yards rushing. Steele had a big first half. That's TJ or Tommy Steele, 49 yards on 2 catches. Both of his catches were in pay dirt for touchdowns. Bishop Luers passing. Nieves still has not completed a pass to a Bishop Luers Knight. 0 for 5 with 1 interception. Rushing is where the Knights are getting it done, guys. They're averaging 7.6 yards per carry. Charlton, 9 carries for 69 yards. Hambright, 6 carries, 29 yards. 103 yards rushing in the first half for the Bishop Luers Knights.
All right, folks, stick around after this 30-second break. We're going to check in with our panel of football experts here, talk about the first half and also what we might see in the second half. 14-0 is your score as the Bishop Dwenger Saints are on top of the Bishop Luers Knights. We're back in 30 seconds. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio 106.3 FM.
Save money, save energy, and make your home more comfortable. Just call Mopper Insulation to re-insulate your existing home. By adding insulation to ceilings and attics, sidewalls, crawl spaces, and basements, your home will stay warmer this winter, and you'll see a noticeable drop in your energy usage. And that translates into savings. Insulation is all we do at Mopper. Expert installers and the best materials mean no gaps, no leaks, and no wasted energy. Call Mopper Insulation today at 432-7543.
We are back to live action here. We've got about 4 minutes and 41 seconds remaining here in the halftime presentation where the Bishop Dwenger Saints are leading the Bishop Luers Knights 14-0. Guys, we talked about the numbers in the first half. Joe Wharton, what is jumping out at you when you look at those numbers?
Well, when I look at these numbers, what jumps out at me is 7.6 yards rushing per carry for the Knights. Remember, the Saints came in only allowing 2 yards per carry. So the Knights are getting it done on the ground. Also, everything else is pretty in line, I think. That's the one thing that jumps out at me. Obviously, Nieves 0 for 5 with an interception. You know, we talked about a couple times his first start here tonight since week 2. He's obviously a little rusty. Not really getting it done through the air of the Knights, but certainly are on the ground.
Well, they certainly are, and Coach Corey Kitchen joins us as well here up in the box. Corey, when you talk about, just saying being positive and playing all aspects of the game, 0-5 with 1 interception, a balanced attack, that is not.
No, and it's difficult for them, obviously, getting them go through the air. I think we knew coming into the game that they have a great rushing attack. I'm kind of surprised that they haven't stuck with that a little bit more. You've got Deshaun Bussell hurting on the sideline. He's not playing. You've got a new quarterback coming back. Regardless of what you think of who should be playing at the quarterback position, I think that they've got to come with more of a commitment to run the football consistently here in the second half.
Right, and we can bring in the godfather of football and talk about that. Godfather, again, time and time again, we see these two men in the backfield, Charlton and Tyrion Hambright. Hambright runs angry each and every game, and Charlton is just so smooth and so slippery. Would you like to see more out of him?
Well, I really would, just to set up the pass. I know on the first two passes that he was trying to throw, it looked to me as though he was looking for that screen that we talked about on tailgate talk.
Yep.
With Coach Lindsay, because he was looking down and there was nobody deep. So it's just not good. 0-5 on passing. He's got to get better numbers in the second half, or they're going to have to get a shepherd's hook and go back with Kanapke and see what he can do. Because last week, 685 yards is hard to argue with, and they did it on the backs of those two running backs. And that opened up the passing.
Yeah.
But I think that 14-0, the Knights are fortunate, and let's just see if they can't work some magic with this first drive. You always say coulda, woulda, shoulda. They really should have scored there at the end of the first half, but didn't. So, hey, can't do anything about the past. Let's move forward, see if the second half doesn't work better for the Knights. And, of course, I just love the effort of the gold helmets. I mean, both these teams are excellent examples of football players. It's just that tonight the Saints just seem to be a little bit better.
With Luers, in addition to that, with Nieves, doesn't have a whole lot of mobility tonight, it appears, coming back from that injury, which right. concerns me as well, because he's not able to extend the play. If that initial receiver's not open, you know, he's taking some sacks and throwing into some coverage. So I'm concerned about his mobility as well.
So, Joe Warden, the question begs, again, not a whole lot of room on the chalk for the Saints running game. Doing fine through the air so far. Obviously, Steele, favorite receiver for the Saints. What do you look for the Saints here in the second half?
Well, I look for them to establish the run early. If you remember last week in the Concordia game, the Saints came out and took that opening drive in the third quarter and marched right down the field with all runs. Remember, Jason Garrett likes to pound the ball. He's the offensive coordinator this year. You know, but then I look at this defense for the Knights, and I look back to last week in Northrop. They gave up over 600 yards of offense to Northrop last week, mm-hmm. 458 through the air, you know, 150 on the ground. And the Bishop Dwenger Saints so far here in the first half have 42 yards rushing. I really expected the Saints would have more rushing yards, to be quite honest with you, in this game. After watching film with the Knights, I felt like their rush defense just really wasn't where they wanted it to be, and I felt like the Saints could really pound them. And we just haven't seen it yet here tonight.
So, Corey, the question begs for you as well. Are you surprised that the Saints have been as successful through the air? Did you think that they would pull off a first half like that?
You know, I'm not as surprised about the air as I am surprised of the lack of production on the ground, yeah. quite honestly. I agree with Joe completely. I would have thought that that the Knights look vulnerable on the ground, and I'm sure that's what Jason's going to get back to here in the second half. Is try to put that, you know, put it down on the ground and work the clock. But Luers gets the ball first here. If they can mount a drive and put some points on the board, we might have a game.
That's exactly right. We might very well.
Well, Sean, you talk about adjustments. I think the Saints, obviously the Luers Knights have committed to the run here.
Sure.
Especially in the second quarter after the first quarter that Nieves had, and I don't blame them. But, you know, I look for Dave Watercutter, the defense coordinator of the Saints, to possibly get more in a five-man front, really to take the runaway and say, basically, Mr. Nieves, you're going to have to beat us through the air.
Right. All right, folks, we're going to go ahead and step out and take a little 30-second break. When we come back, the third quarter of action is right around the corner. 14-0 is your score. The Bishop Dwenger Saints on top of the Bishop Luers Knights. Again, your third quarter is coming up very quickly. We're back in 30 seconds. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio 106.3 FM.
Successful coaches make changes to succeed by calling timeouts to make needed adjustments, for it's clear no change equals no change. This is David X with Union Savings Bank in Fort Wayne. I started mortgage lending in 1988. Since then, I've been trusted by thousands of area homeowners. I offer low closing costs and great rates on home lending, so you can save big money both up front and over the life of your loan. Make a change for the better when purchasing a different home or refinancing to lower your payment. Call timeout, get your mortgage statement in hand. Call me anytime for your free mortgage checkup. And make sure you compare. Call David X, 418-6191. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Football fans, are you looking for a place where your questions are answered? You can find that right here at Redeemer Radio. Discover programs that will help you discover the richness of the Catholic faith. Check out the program lineup online at RedeemerRadio.com. Welcome home to your family of faith. Well, again, we are wrapping up our halftime presentation here at the Bishop's Bowl. It is Bishop Dwenger 14 and the Bishop Luers Knights 0. I'm Sean McBride, joined by Joe Warden up here in the booth. Joe, what do you have for us?
Well, let's just talk about the scoring summary. The scoring got started in the first quarter at the 6:20 mark. That's when Pichelny hit TJ or Tommy Steele. Why do I keep saying TJ? That's his dad. Tommy Steele for a 7-yard touchdown reception. That made the score 7-0. And then the score rounded out also or at the 3:13 mark in the first when, again, Pichelny and Steele hooked up on a 42-yard touchdown strike. That was 14-0. No scoring in the second quarter, Sean. A couple other things I'd like to mention here. Bishop Dwenger, third down conversions in the first half. They were 5 of 8, and that was after completing. They were 4 for 4 on the first four third down tries, 1 for 4 on their next four. Penalties for the Saints, 3 penalties in the first half for 25 yards. The Knights, 2 out of 5 on third down conversions. 1 turnover was an interception by Nieves, and penalties for the Knights in the first half, only 4 for 30 yards.
All righty. So those are your first half roundabout stats right there. Again, we're preparing for the third quarter kickoff where the Bishop Luers Knights will get the ball first. But just a reminder, folks, tomorrow, what a great deal we have in store for you. If you can't make it out to Bishop Darcy Stadium, keep it locked right here on Redeemer Radio as the number one Marion Knights come into Fort Wayne to take on your University of St. Francis Cougars. Number one versus number two. They're labeling it the Franciscan Bowl. And what a great game it is going to be here at Bishop Darcy Stadium. Joe Parson and I on the call tomorrow, 11:45 is when we go live on the air. And then again, come out and talk about the game tomorrow night at the Bishop Luers Smoker right here. Festivities begin at 7 p.m. under the tent right here on the beautiful campus of Bishop Luers High School. Great time and great fun and great food as the godfather of football will be signing 8x10 glosses.
Right. I thought he would be signing 8x10s as well, but he corrected us. He said they're going to be 10x10s.
10x10.
He needs that wider picture paper.
All right. The teams are on the field, and let's check in with the man himself.
Oh, Joe, you got to let me make the jokes. Come on now. 10x10s.
He is good stuff.
He is. C.J. Booth preparing to kick the ball off and as we begin the third quarter of action. Kicking right to left on your radio dial are the Bishop Dwenger Saints. Back deep is the Tyrion Hambright for the Bishop Luers Saints. And it is a low liner on the ground, taking a few hops, taken by the up back this time, looking for some room, bouncing it outside. That is, Gaston from his up back position, giving the Knights good field position out to the 41.
And the Evans is still the quarterback here. And you know, here's the deal, Sean. The Knights have three losses on the season. At this point, with three games remaining, you're trying to get ready for the playoffs.
Right.
He needs these games. He's your senior. He's their guy. He started the season.
Yep.
Okay, regardless of how he does tonight, I think we're going to see the full four quarters of Nieves. It's about getting ready for the second season, which is the playoffs.
Twins right and left, single setback for the Knights. Nieves in the shotgun. Here's a snap. Throw out, little hitch pattern. Gilly has it. It is caught. Not much room there as... Look at all those gold helmets, Godfather. They're swarming over Gilly.
Guys, they're so well coached. Those guys swarm the football like a bunch of bees. That gold, I thought they were yellow jackets.
That is good. Gilly catches his sixth pass of the season. I like the call there early, Sean, for
right.
Nieves. Give him something to get some confidence, yep. An easy out route.
Yeah, the first completion there on the game for Nieves. And we call that a 2, maybe 3 yard gainer for the Bishop Luers Knights at the 44 yard line. Here's a snap from shotgun. Give to Charlton. Left side sweep following his blocker. Gets wrangled
wow.
And stuffed.
Wow.
Good heavens. Haven't seen a hit like that in quite a while.
A big hit over there. Looked like Bloom and Hoss Henry on the stop.
Limited that gain to only a few. They get it out from the 44 out to the 47. And that brings up a 3rd and 4 for the Knights. As Nieves comes in from the sidelines with the play. Again, third quarter action, 14-0 is your score. In case you're just joining us, the Saints on top of the Knights. Knights with the ball, first possession of the third quarter. Critical third down here from their own 47 with split backs, two wide outs to the right. Nieves barks out the signal. Here's a snap. And it is a, again, that cross buck through the middle. And Charlton has enough for the first down, gets into Dwenger territory, still on his feet past the 40, inside the 40 to about the 35-yard line. That's a counter trade. Godfather, what'd you see?
Well, it's that counter trade, but it's also what Coach Kitchen was talking about, that, hey, if they get to running that football, they're going to see some success in the second half. And look at 3 yards, 4 yards, then 15 yards.
Yep.
Yeah, big. The Knights caught the Saints in a blitz. Both inside linebackers came on a blitz, and the ball went outside, and there was no linebackers to fill over there.
First and 10 for the Knights inside Saints territory at the 35-yard line. Twins right and left working off the left hash mark. Nieves from the shotgun. Here's a snap. He looks to throw, looking left. Ball is hit. No, it is caught. And that is going to be Brooks on the catch, number 2. And I think he's going to have enough for a first down.
Brooks gets his seventh catch of the season, Sean.
All right. And they will move the chain. So first and 10 again on that quick hitch to Brooks inside the 25 to the 24-yard line.
the Knights offense is making it look easy against this Dwenger defense here in this first drive of the third quarter.
Moving right down the field they are. First and 10 for the Knights. Two wideouts left and right. Now a man in motion to the right side. They fake it to him, give it to Charlton through the middle. Oh, he's stuffed. Falls forward for maybe one, possibly two, if any.
Yeah, that's the Honey Badger. That's Isaac Cornwell there in the middle linebacker position, filling his hole and doing a great job.
So gain of one that time. Brings up a second and 9. Yard marker is wrong. That they're showing third down. It's second down. Okay, there's a change. All righty. Split backs this time. Two wideouts to the right. Nieves in the shotgun on second and long. Here is a snap. Draw play going to the right side. That's Hambright going around the edge looking for the seam. Cuts it. No, he can't get much there as he gets down to the 20. So good pursuit angles by the Saints defense there, Joe.
Wow, great play by Mike Hake right there because Trey Underwood pulled and absolutely blew him up, and he went flying through the air but kept his feet and then fought off Underwood and got in and made that tackle. That was a great effort by 32 with a golden helmet.
That brings up a third and 5 now, so gain of 4 on that play. Ball resting just inside the red zone at the 20. They break huddle, split back, two wideouts left. Hard count by Nieves, doesn't pull him off. Here's a give to Charlton, left side, finds a seam, gets cutting up through the middle. He's got the first down and more. And that will be a nice run again by Jalen Charlton. So tough to spring him down.
Yeah, well blocked on the left side of the offensive line over there to spring Charlton for a nice pickup. Again, these Knights average 7.5 yards a carry in the first half, and we're seeing why.
Yeah, he got 10 on that one. And that's going to bring up a first and goal for the Knights from the 10-yard line off of the 10-yard carry by Charlton. Again, split backs. This time two wideouts to the right as they work off the left hash mark. Here's the snap. Going to the right side is Hambright. Breaks out of one tackle to the right side. Gets north. Oh, we've got a flag on the play.
Red zone penalty, Sean.
Yep. He's going to get stopped at about the 8-yard line here on the close side of the field. Again, as they stretch those plays out, it's so difficult for those linemen, Joe, to not hold.
Yeah.
You know? It really is.
You're exactly right. And I'll tell you this, the Saints were in a 5-man front on that play.
There
so,
you go.
Again, tired of watching them run roughshod through there. They dropped an extra lineman in.
Yeah, so a red zone penalty from the 8 or the 9 takes the ball back out to the 19-yard line. And it will remain first and goal now from the 19 for the Knights. That's a tough one.
Those things make coaches absolutely crazy.
Yes. Split backs, two wideouts on the short side, the right, one wide left. Here is a snap. He looks to throw, looking over, fires over the middle, over the head, and incomplete. Off of the hands of his intended receiver that time, and incomplete.
Yeah, the ball was actually tipped, and luckily for the Knights, it was not intercepted.
Yeah.
That is Nieves' first incompletion of this second half.
Yeah, that's Zach Wood, number 16, the sophomore split end that time. He goes 5'10", 150 pounds, was not able to get that ball. And a little tip drill, but it ended up just short of Watercutter's hands. So second and goal from the 19-yard line now for Bishop Luers. Two wideouts to the left with split backs. Wood wide right. He looks right, throws it, ball is hit, no, incomplete that time. Wood was met trying to get that catch, and the ball just popped right out.
That was T.J. McGeary in coverage. T.J. McGeary is a sophomore, 5'10", 180, and he's been working in at linebacker a little bit. They really are high on T.J. McGeary. He's going to be a heck of a player for the Saints
and
team.
Well, we've seen him run the ball very
well.
Yeah,
we have. Yeah. He's a running back, he's a linebacker, he just plays the game the right way, plays it really hard. Jacob Fabini checks into the game as Hoss Henry checks out.
Third and goal now for the Knights from the 19-yard line. Two wideouts left and right. Single setback is Brower. Here's the snap. A little low. Nieves has it. Looks. He's got some pressure. Still trying to find someone. Gets hit as he throws the ball in and out of the hands of Wood that time. And so that drive is going to stall. Let's see what they do here. Godfather, what do you have?
Well, hey, that drive is going to stall, but it makes you wonder, hey, you know, they get that penalty, and then they went away from what got them down the field, and that's the running game.
Yep.
Three passes in a row and more incompletion.
Hey, guys, in for the field goal is the Knights are going to go for the field goal. They are 2 out of 4 on field goals this season.
So we're going to call this a 35-yard attempt by Peyton Howe, number 8.
His long's 32 this year.
From the right hash mark, the kick is up. And is it, oh, a little wide left, unfortunately, for young Mr. Howe. He cannot put that through the uprights. And, again, the Knights had a first and goal from the 10-yard line. Penalty brought it back, 3 incompletions, and then they were not able to capitalize. So the Saints dodge a bullet on that one, Joe.
They sure do, and so now we're going to see what the Bishop Dwenger Saints are going to do here on their first drive. Now, we talked at halftime, and I thought they would do be a run-heavy series here for them, which means they'll probably pass a lot.
Yeah, that's right. You know, Peyton might get some grief from the Gold Helmets over there. He's got cousins, Ryer, Charlie, and Harrison, that play for Bishop Dwenger.
Oh,
and,
no doubt.
So this is a big game for the Howe family. And, you know, both those grandpas are probably going at it all day today.
A little trash talk in the Howe
Absolutely.
Family.
You bet. Here come the Saints from the 20-yard line off the missed field goal attempt. Pichelny under center, I formation. Here's a snap, and we've got a flag. And that could very well be a false start. Oh, they're motioning offsides. So it looks like maybe, what do we have here?
Offsides on the defense.
Yeah, so somebody lined up in the neutral zone. Another penalty for Bishop Luers there. So free 5 yards for the Bishop Dwenger Saints. Takes it out to the 25-yard line. Steele and Houck out wide left for the Saints. Twins to the right and a single setback. Pichoni in the shotgun. On 1st and 5 from the 25. Here's a snap. Quarterback draw through the middle. He's hitting the backfield. Falling forward, getting something positive out of it. Gain of 2, maybe 3.
I tell you what, Hoss Henry pulled there, the right guard, and he just is, he's one young man I would not want to see coming at me. He really brings it.
That he does. Dom Easley on the stop that time for Bishop Luers. Talked about him all night.
All night long. That kid's a player.
He is. Brings up 2nd and 3 now for the Saints. Wildcat formation. Pichelny in the wing to the right. Oh, they break it up. Trey Underwood hits him in the backfield, and he is going to be stopped finally. He broke the initial hit. Falls forward. That still will be a tackle for loss.
Yeah, Trey Underwood, he just stunted from his defensive tackle position and absolutely got a step on the line and blew it up in the backfield. Here's the deal with Wildcat. If you're a defensive player, you know when they go in Wildcat, it's a run.
Yeah, that's
so
exactly
you
right.
Can have those kitchen sink blitzes where you bring everybody when they line up in the Wildcat, and that's what you saw Luers do right there. They brought everybody.
Yeah, Effinger didn't stand a chance on that one. And that brings up a 3rd and 7, so a loss of 5 on that one for the Saints. Under center is Pichelny with an I formation on 3rd and 7. Play action, he rolls out to the right, throws it deep left side. He's got a man open. Oh, he's hit immediately, and a flag comes out.
Yeah. Underthrown ball. Tommy Steele had beaten his man by probably 5 yards. Tommy Steele had to completely stop and turn around, wait for it. The defender never turned around. He ran right into Tommy Steele. Obvious call, easy call for the officials.
So another penalty on Bishop Luers will move the chains for the Knights. This is third quarter action, 5:44 remaining in the third quarter. 14-0 is your score. Dwenger on top as they prepare to mark off the penalty yardage here.
15-yarder.
Yep. They take it out to the 39-yard line. And
so right here in the third quarter, the Knights already have 3 penalties for 30 yards.
Trips to the right, empty backfield with Pichelny now. And a quick throw coming. He's going deep this time. And he's got water cutter, but he caught it out of bounds.
Brad Black,
84, yeah.
Bradley Black, glad to see him catch it. Had a tough week last week, but listen, you got to go back to him. He's a ball player.
That's right.
And he's got wheels. And Pichelny ran down the field here to give him a high five. So it's all about confidence.
Yep. Well, he knew that was on him. That was on Pichelny. He threw it 6 inches out of bounds and couldn't get it.
What should be concerning for Bishop Luers is that the Knights receivers are consistently getting behind their
right.
DBs.
That's exactly
consistently.
Right. Yeah, you're absolutely right. Stop saying that. Say that a lot. Second and 10 now for the Bishop Dwenger Saints. Man in motion coming to the close side of the field. And here's a snap, and I think we got too many men moving.
Yes.
False start against Bishop Dwenger. So instead of second and 10, we've got second and 15 now for the Bishop Dwenger Saints. Again, still in their own territory. This moves the ball back to their own 39-yard line. Or check that, 34-yard line. They were at the 39.
I do like to see that they're rolling Pichelny out tonight. We haven't seen much of that at all this year, but he can definitely throw on the ball.
Oh, he can, absolutely. Yeah. I like his mechanics when he does that, his shoulders. You
he
know,
gets
when
turned. He, and, yeah.
Trips right, two to the left, empty backfield. Quick throw. Oh, the receiver goes down and can't make it. That's Black again.
He fell down.
He fell down as he twisted. And that brings up third and 15. So the Bishop Dwenger Saints hard up against it now. Again, without that penalty, really not much on this drive here, Joe.
If you look at the Saints' last six tries at third down, it's been third and 10, third and 25, third and 10, third and 3, third and 7, third and 15. A lot of third and longs in there, Sean.
You're right. 5.5 to go in the third quarter. On third and 15. Trip to the right, single setback.
Blitz.
Draw play through the middle. He breaks one tackle. He's off to the races. He gets downfield. Oh, he's going to be close to a first down, but won't have it. Mitch Effinger that time with a very nice run. Breaks a tackle in the backfield. He gets downfield. Yeah. To the 46.
Great play call because as the Knights have done all night, when it's an obvious passing situation, they blitz. You saw it there, so you blitz. We run a draw. There's no linebacker there to stop the running back. And good call by Jason Bear.
Just shy, fourth and 3 now for the Bishop Dwenger Saints, and the punt team is on. Pichelny will kick this one from about his own 37, maybe 38. Two men back deep, Gaston and Gilly for the Knights, standing about their own 25.
Pichelny averaging 30 yards per punt this season.
Good snap. Kick is away. Nice kick. Well downfield. Hits inside the 10 and is going to stop right at the 10-yard line.
Wow, that looked like the Godfather sand wedge right there, how he just stuck it right there.
He parachuted it in.
He did.
Yeah. Go ahead, Godfather.
I know the Knights had some trouble with their punt snaps, but this Colin Canary seems to be over it. When he snaps that ball, it's right where it needs to be, and the guy's got a good chance for getting a great kick, and there was a great example.
Good call. You're absolutely yeah. Good call. We see that.
Yeah, Colin
Canary. His name is Canary, right? Is that right?
Yeah, it's Canary, and I like what he does after he snaps the ball. I watched a couple collisions he was making out there. Reminds me of his dad and his Uncle Dave.
All right. Here come the Bishop Luers Knights with 90 yards to go. Nieves in the shotgun with split backs. Here's a snap. A little low. He's got it. Here's a counter going to the right side. Finding some room. Getting north. A little more breathing room out there. Gain of a couple, maybe three.
There's about 9 gold helmets on Charlton on that play. Or handbrake, excuse me.
So we'll call that a gain of 3. Brings up a 2nd and 7. As Nieves is back in the huddle with his offensive unit. And here they come. You're going to have 2 wideouts to the left side. That's Gilly and Brooks out there. Split backs. Here's a snap. He looks to throw. Looking left. Throwing off the ground and incomplete to Brooks.
Tommy Steele in coverage for Bishop Ware. But that ball never had a chance. Really
no chance.
A couple yards in front of the intended receiver.
So 3:48 remaining here in the third quarter. 14-0 is your score. Bishop Dwenger on top of the Bishop Luers Knights. Godfather, what do you have?
I'm just curious down here. Do we have any complete passes yet?
We've got one hitch, I thought.
No,
one?
Two. He's completed two.
Yeah, two.
Two for...
We'll get that for you, Coach.
Thank you.
Two for 11. 11 yards so far. On third and a long seven. Here's the snap. Nieves looks to throw again. He's got time. Going deep. Airs it out. Man coverage. That should be flagged.
It is.
Yep, absolutely. Wood was the intended receiver for the Bishop Luers Knights, and that was clearly a penalty.
Sam Overfeld, the sophomore, getting the start here tonight because Bradley Black was dinged up a little bit. So Sam Overfeld getting some more playing time, and he just got caught on a little double move and was trying to make up ground and ran into the receiver. Good call by the officials.
Dave X?
Yeah, good call by the officials, but there I think that would have been three completions had he not been hit because that was a pretty good throw.
There you go.
First and 10 now for the Bishop Luers Knights after the penalty is assessed. They move the ball out to the 27-yard line. Split backs, give to Charlton, tries to find his way around the right, nothing there. Steps out of a tackle, goes north right through the middle.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Charlton will stop 4 yards deep. 4 yards deep in the backfield and somehow finds a way to break free and pick up almost 5 yards.
He stopped on a dime on wet turf. I mean, that is just incredible. Dave, what'd you see down there?
Well, it's just, it just takes me back. I have to smile. It reminds me of my brother, Mike X. When he coached here, he used to tell Coach Lindsay, run the football!
Yeah.
Okay.
Run the ball.
Gain of five that time for Charlton. Turns a sow's ear into a silk purse that time. Again, those split backs. From the shotgun, he looks to throw. Nieves throws it, and it's off the hands. Again, Brooks on the right side, close to the sidelines here. Had to go low to try and get it, and another incompletion brings up a third and five now.
Yeah, good ball there thrown by Nieves. Again, this Knights team averaging 280 yards per game on the ground, guys. I mean, they've got a great ground attack, no question about it.
Third and five, third quarter action. Knights moving left to right on your radio dial. Split backs, two wide outs to the left, one wide right on the short side. Here's the snap. Nieves looks, fires over the middle. He's got Brooks this time. It's caught at the 45. Gets tripped up at the 50. And it looks like they're going to spot him at the 49 of Bishop Luers.
Pass was completed just in front of free safety, Alec Watercutter. Great throw, great catch for the Knights. Chains are moving. Here we go.
The drive stays alive into Bishop Dwenger territory. They mark it at the 49. And Nieves comes in from the sideline. Again, third quarter action. We're down to about 2.5 minutes here. Knights down two scores. 14-0 is your score.
Five-man front for the Saints.
Yep. And here they try the middle. Oh, and he finds room, and he's off to the races. That's Charlton again with a huge carry down deeper into Bishop Dwenger territory. They're going to mark him at about the 34-yard line.
Wow, five-man front, and nobody touches Charlton. Yeah. There's no excuse for that, and the Saints call a timeout, and I think you're exactly right. Come on, somebody's got to put a hand on that running back.
A 15-yard run that time by Jalen Charlton, and a first down coming up for the Bishop Luers Knights. Stick around, folks. We're back after this 30-second break. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio 106.3 FM.
A clean office space. Okay, that's an easy choice. And choosing the right company to clean your business is easy, too. Siokas Professional Cleaning is the choice of a lot of Fort Wayne companies because of the 100% satisfaction guarantee. Siokas does it with built-in check systems to make sure your business is cleaned beyond your expectations every time. First impressions are critical, so make sure yours is always the best with professional cleaning from Siokas. The best people, the best service. 483-2112 or online at siokas.com.
Football fans, historic St. Felix Catholic Center is open for retreats. Located in Huntington, Indiana on 30 scenic acres, with plenty of recreational areas and a serene Blessed Mother Grotto. You can plan your visit today by checking them out online at www.sfcatholiccenter.com. First and 10 now for the Bishop Luers Knights in Saints territory at their 34-yard line. Here is the snap. Again, give to Charlton. Gets out of one tackle, gets through the line, gets into the linebacker core, gets about maybe seven or eight before he stood up and stopped.
Riley Miller came on the blitz, had Charlton sized up in the backfield, and Charlton just cut and left him standing there. It is amazing what Charlton can do.
He's
6'3", 200 pounds. I mean, he looks like a major D1 player out here.
Gain of seven that time for the Bishop Luers Knights in Charlton. To about the 28, maybe the 27 down there, working off the middle of the field. Again, single setback is Charlton. Nieves in the shotgun. Double tights. Five-man front for Dwenger. Give to Charlton again. Tries to break around to the outside. He's got the right side. He's got the corner. Gets down to the 10. Gets down inside the 10 near the 5-yard line. Jalen Charlton running roughshod over the Dwenger defense right now.
Wow, the Momo has shifted to the black jerseys. I can guarantee you that, folks. This defense is getting gashed.
Godfather, what do you have?
Well, sometimes you want to put teams away, and the Saints just haven't done that. They've let these Knights stick around, and it might come back and haunt them. We got to see if the Knights can take advantage of this drive and get in that end zone, make it a one-score game.
Another interesting twist right now, number 32, Mike Hake, getting helped off the field for the Bishop Dwenger Saints, limping a little bit, favoring one of the legs.
Mike Hake's played a lot on both sides of the ball tonight. T.J. McGarry is his replacement on our two-deep chart. Will Kohler is in at defensive end now for he came in for Luther Hall, and they ran right at Will Kohler right there. Tough assignment.
First and goal now for the Bishop Luers Knights. They place the ball at the 7-yard line. High formation. Nieves under center. Here's a quick give to Charlton. Tries his way around the left side. And he does get the edge. Does he get in?
The official fell down.
Goes down.
Touchdown.
There it is. There's the score. Touchdown, Bishop Luers.
The official got trampled over there and fell down, but he got back to his feet. He's a gamer.
So a 7-yard score by Jalen Charlton puts the Knights back in the game. Peyton Howe comes on for the PAT. Line up the ball. Gilly's hold is down. It is good. The kick is up, and it is good. Peyton Howe with another point on the board for the Bishop Luers Knights. Your score now 14-7 with 1:11 left in the third quarter. We're going to step out for a 30-second break. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio, 106.3 FM.
Amore's Pizza proudly supports Catholic sports. Try our Chicago-style stuffed pizza made with top-quality meats and cheeses. Your mouth will taste the difference. We also offer gluten-free options or many unique items. Amore's Pizza is located at 933 East DuPont Road, right off Coldwater. Full menu and specials can be found at amorespizza.net or call 490-9099. Amore's Pizza, where our food is made with love.
Welcome back to Live Action, ladies and gentlemen. It is 1:11 left in the third quarter, where the Bishop Luers Knights have now struck back in the score 14-7. Let's check in with Nick Gray.
Well, guys, you can hear the Bishop Luers student section behind me going crazy. What a great evening. Carroll did score, so right now Homestead's still winning that, but it's 21-10, so Carroll's narrowing the gap there. Snyder's destroying Northrop 47-0. Southside at Northside, last I heard, it's still 7-6, Southside leading that one.
Yep.
Concordia's up on Wayne, 34-8. New Haven's beating Belmont, 28-10. DeKalb's winning at Norwell, 38-0. So that's pretty much it for now. Back up to you guys.
All right, thanks very much, Nick Gray. Here comes the Bishop Luers kickoff. Peyton Howe puts his leg into it. It's a deep kick this time, edging toward the end zone and goes in. So a touchback here for the Bishop Luers Saints.
Can the Saints answer? I mean, this is a big time, Sean.
Okay? Yeah.
This is a brawl. This is a backstreet brawl, the battle of the bishops. I mean, who They just got punched, okay? The Saints just got punched by the Knights. Can they counterpunch? That's what we're going to find out.
Great question. Let's find out on this drive as Blake Picelny, the senior quarterback, leads his offense back out onto the field. They're going to have, again, that trips package to the right side. A single setback, one wide left. From the shotgun. Here's Picelny going to the left side, trying to find that seam. Not much there. The ball is on the ground, and it's covered up.
Yeah, not much there. The defensive line for the Knights are fired up. They're in the backfield. That offensive line for the Saints is going to have to step up. And Picelny comes up a little gimpy, guys. Keep an eye on that guy.
Oh, yeah. That's exactly right. So we're going to call that a loss of one back to the 19-yard line for the Saints. Dave X.
That doggone ball was too close to me. I broke down. I thought I had my helmet on. I was about ready to run out there myself and jump on it.
Don't get out there. You'll get hurt.
I've got issues.
All right, second and 11 for the Bishop Dwenger Saints. Wing to the right side, single setback. Picelny under center this time. And it's a play action. He's got time. He's looking to throw, going deep, right side, looking for his receiver. It is in and out.
There's
of the hands.
Flag.
A flag coming out. He went for a steal, and yeah, that was a.
I think it's another easy call for officials.
Yeah, I think you're right.
On the interference call. Of course, we're at Luers, and people in the booth don't share our sentiment. But from here, it looked like a good.
So again, the single coverage out there on the far right side. They go deep, and the defender gets burned on the pass interference call. And that's going to be a 15-yarder for the Saints.
I did not see who that was in coverage, Sean.
Yeah.
Not that it matters.
Yeah. I think that may have been Chris Edwards.
First down, Saints.
Can't confirm that.
Can't. We're not going to confirm it.
Doesn't matter. Yeah. All right. So here come the Saints on first and 10 now at the 34-yard line of the other, well, excuse me, they're on 34 on their same side of the ball. Man in motion now coming to the left side. They flow left. There's going to be an option. Sturm hits him in the backfield. Picelny has to keep it and doesn't get anywhere.
Sturm on the stop. Nice job. But let me make a point. Let me go back to that last pass play. That might be the first time I've seen the Saints run a pass from under center. So,
seeing
changes some things up.
And now we've got a timeout on the field. That does it, ladies and gentlemen, for your third quarter. Fourth quarter action coming up. 14-7 is your score, and the momentum has clearly shifted to the Bishop Luers Knights. We're back in 1 minute. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio 106.3 FM.
You can help support your Catholic parish or school with Notre Dame Federal Credit Union's Elevate program. You'll not only enjoy excellent personal service and save money with your new loan or credit card, you'll also be giving money back to the participating parish or school you care about. Let Notre Dame Federal Credit Union elevate all participating parishes or schools. Elevate can be reached at 844-230-6611 or visit us online at ndelevate.com. Independent from the university.
Programming on Redeemer Radio is underwritten in part by Bob Busher Homes. Floor plan customization is what they specialize in. Find floor plans, building sites, and read Bob's story on the web at bobbusherhomes.com. Bob Busher Homes is locally owned with offices in Fort Wayne and Angola. For more information about new home building or remodeling, Bob Busher Homes can be reached at 260-490-3355.
We are back to live action, and to start the fourth quarter, the Bishop Dwenger Saints run it right up the gut on a beautiful trap play that time. Very well executed into Bishop Luers territory, down to the 47-yard line.
A great run there. It looked like Effinger, just, you said it, Sean, just an inside trap right off the center's backside, and a huge hole. Big pickup for the Saints. Good to see the Saints run the ball, or at least have a hole at least.
That's right.
Right.
First and 10 for the Saints. Down at the Luers 47-yard line. Picelny under center now with a single setback. Here is a snap. Play action. Throwing to the right side. He's got his man. Oh, in and out of the hands. And that is steal.
Yeah, a little behind him, but steal is went up and almost made a great catch there. Ball was a little behind steal.
Brings up a second and 10. Again, we have just turned the clock over. 11 and a half to go here in the fourth quarter. 14-7 is your score. Saints on top. Bishop's Bowl 2016. Pichelny under center now. Wing back to the right. Snap pitch, right side. Looking for some room. He won't find any whatsoever.
Barry.
Anton Barry. Comes in along with Trey Underwood, and no gain on the play. Brings up a third and 10. Joe, you talked about this. Third downs for the Saints have not looked good in the majority of this game.
Third and longs.
Yeah.
First and second down, for the most part, have not been very good for the Saints offense.
Third down 10.
Steele checking in for the Saints as Pichelny barks out the play. They break huddle, come to the line on third and 10 from the Luers 47. Twins right, twins left, single setback.
Look for the Knights to blitz. That's what they've been doing all night and passing down. Here they
come.
There's
a snap. Blitz coming. It's not picked up. Pichelny slips a little bit, throws the ball.
Oh,
in and out of the hands of Hout. So the incompletion right there, and the defense holds for Bishop Luers.
A couple drop passes here in the third quarter, so punting situation for the fourth quarter, excuse me, for the Saints. And Sean, we're going to see now, I bet, a lot of Jalen Charlton.
Yes.
And Hambright. What do you think?
I would agree with you completely.
Yeah.
On fourth and 10 now. Punt formation in for the Saints. Pichelny will launch this from about his 43. Gaston and Gilly back deep inside their own 20-yard line. Here is a high end-over-end kick. Good punt that time, and it's going to trickle into the end zone. And a touchback coming up for the Bishop Luers Knights. So the Knights come back out on offense. Let's check in with Dave X.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, I'm just so surprised that the Saints aren't able to move the ball after they had so much success in the first two possessions of having the ball. The Knights must have made some adjustments. We know no change equals no change. The Knights had to make some defensive changes to be stopping these guys. And I sense the Momo, and I know if those Knights get in that end zone, they very well may not go for one.
Hey, Godfather, here's a fact you might like. Pichelny is 0 for his last six pass attempts.
No. I don't. I like
Come
Pichelny.
On, Godfather.
I like Pichelny. I think he's a state championship quarterback.
Here are the Knights on first and 10. They try the end around on the left side. Pass the 20 out to the 21, maybe the 22. As Charlton on the carry that time.
Frankie Yanko got into the backfield and tracked down Charlton. Listen, if there's one guy on the Saints defense that can turn the tide, it's that guy, number 59, Frank Yanko, the buzzsaw.
Second and 8 coming up. Dave X, what do you have?
If I can't have my Winkle, John, I got to have my Frankie Yanko.
There you go.
He plays.
Second and long coming up for Bishop Luers now. Split backs, two wideouts to the right. Nieves in the shotgun. Here's a snap. Goes to the right side, looking, fires. Oh, it's tipped at the line and incomplete.
I love that. It was either Yanko or Henry got a big paw up there, and I do mean paw, and knocked that one down. So big third down here for the Knights.
Third and long, third and 8 coming up now for the Knights. Again, their defense was strong. They held, give the offense an opportunity here.
The Knights have converted on 3 of their 4 third down attempts here in the second half, guys. The Saints defense has not been able to get them off the field in the second half.
Well, they threw on second down there. Interesting call. Let's see what they do here on third and long. Twins right, twins left, single setback. Nieves in the shotgun. Here's a snap. He's looking to throw. Looks over the middle. He's got pressure. He tries to run. He's caught. And he goes down at
Who
the
else?
22. There he is. Frankie Yanko.
The buzzsaw gets his 6th sack of the season. And now Will Kohler goes hopping out. Remember, he's the backup defensive end that was in for Hall. So now Bart Tittman checks into the game. Another reserve defensive end, senior.
Hey, now in to kick this one away. Tippin back deep for the Saints. And fair catch called for a water cutter that time on the reception. So the Saints will have great field position here after the punt. They're going to take over first and 10 near their own 48-yard line. Well, again, fourth quarter action, 14-7 with 9:05 remaining here in the Bishop's Bowl. And now they are going to move it back a yard and mark it at the 47.
The Saints offense is ranked number 7 in the SAC. And, Sean, that's just not something that we're used to seeing. Number 7. Pichelny is averaging 160 yards per game. He's going to need to connect on a few passes here to try to bump this lead up 2 scores.
Let's see what happens on 1st and 10 from their own 47-yard line. Pichelny under center, wing to the right, single setback. Here's a snap. They're going to try through the middle. And they're going to push their way forward. Gain of a couple, maybe to the midfield stripe. Depends upon the spot. Is that Hudson on the carry?
That was Jordan Hudson on the carry. And Swain, Mr. Swain, the senior defensive lineman, on the stop for the Knights.
Gain of a couple to the 49-yard line. Saints with lots of time left in this game. Knights with lots of time left in this game as well. Hudson now has to be repositioned. He's going to be offset to the right side, go in motion behind the quarterback. Here is a snap. Give to Hudson through the middle, puts a shoulder into it. Big push that time as Richard brings him down. He's going to get across the midfield stripe down to the 46-yard line of the Knights.
Jordan Hudson is a guy who this staff has been, you know, high on. He has a lot of talent and just been nicked up a lot of the season, so he hasn't had as many touches as you'd like to see, but it looks like maybe they're going to start feeding this guy now. Jordan Hudson's a junior running back, 5'10", 186. And if he gets an open space, guys, look out, because he can go.
Cornwall checks in, wing to the left side. Hudson wing to the right, now in motion again behind the quarterback. Here's a snap. Give it to Hudson again, trying to find his way through the middle. He is wrapped up at the line and dropped. Not much there at all, if any.
78 on the stop for Bishop Luers. Of course, that's Zach Starks. And now he's cramping up. The Saints have to punt. 3 and out. What a defensive stand there for the Knights. What a stand for the Knights when they needed it.
And now we've got a timeout on the field to take care of that night. 4th and 3 for the Bishop Dwenger Saints. Ball resting at the 46-yard line of Bishop Luers. And both teams coming off to get a splash right here. So again, folks, just a reminder that tomorrow, great day of football here on Redeemer Radio. The University of St. Francis, number 2 in the nation, taking on the Marion Knights, number 1 in the nation, at Bishop Darcy Stadium. Pregame show starts at 11:45 with Joe Parson. We go live at noon with all the great action. If you can't make it out to the station, be sure and tune in to Redeemer Radio. And again, catch all the action around the world at www.redeemerradio.com. Let's check in with Nick Gray.
Well, guys, Carroll did score, and they went for 2. So that game is starting to become a barn burner, too. And Homestead's leading it, though, 21-18. I did confirm Southside at Northside. Southside's still winning that one, 7-6. Guess they've had Southside's had some other opportunities but missed them. So those are the 2 hot ones besides this one. Back up to you guys.
All righty. On 4th and 3, the Dwenger punt team is in. Pichelny kicks this one away. It's a high in-over-in kick. Going to be very short this time, and it's going to go out of bounds north of the 20. And let's see where the official walks it up to the 24-yard line.
Yeah, not a very good punt there. Looked like it went off the side of Pichelny's foot. Short punt. So here we go. If you're a Knights fan, here you go. 7 minutes to go here in the 4th quarter. 7 minutes to go in this game, Sean. Saints lead 14-7.
Nieves comes in from the sideline to give the play to the offense for the Bishop Luers Knights. Again, the Knights wearing all black tonight with the white numerals and red trim. Saints wearing gold with the white jerseys and navy numerals. Nieves in the shotgun with a single setback. Here's a give to Charlton, tries the edge, not much there, stopped at the line of scrimmage, great small tackle, ball is knocked out of bounds and not recovered. And let's see where they're going to spot this. He'll have a small gain on the play.
That's only the 3rd time, Sean, that Charlton's put it on the ground all year, and he has not lost a fumble all season. I have to mention, Jose Lopez just gave me the stat. So far in this game, the Bishop Luers Knights have 207 yards rushing. That's 207. And that's against a defense that has only allowed 57 yards per game this year. They are getting it done on the ground.
That they are. call that a loss of two, actually, bringing up a second and 12 now for the Knights. Same formation, single setback, double tights. Here's a snap, fake to Charlton, play action, throwing over the middle, over the hands, and incomplete. Going for Anton Berry, just couldn't wrangle it in, which is surprising considering he checks in at 6'6".
6'6", and you overthrow 6'6", you're really overthrown. Anton Berry comes into this game with one catch on the season. He's looking to double his totals there on that one play.
Couldn't bring that one in, and that brings up a third and long now for the Knights. Fourth quarter action. They stop the clock at 7:02 to go. 14-7 is your score. Saints clinging to a seven-point lead.
Cling is right, Sean. Good yeah. word there. Good word usage.
Pick skinny and knowledge.
You're very good.
Pro set this time on third and long. Looks to the right, checks off. He's got some pressure, dances around, looking for some direction, rolls out, throws it downfield, and it is going to be an incomplete pass. Trying to find Gilly as he tiptoed down the sidelines. And again, a three and out for Bishop Luers. So both teams trading three and outs now, Joe.
Well, I'll tell you what, the Saints did very good right there, and I don't think they did a very good job last week of it. When that back finally decided he was going to come out of the backfield and look to get into a route, there was a linebacker right there right now to pick him up. And Evans was looking for the running back, but he was covered.
He had no outlet.
Well done by the linebackers.
Peyton Howe again back to punt this one away. Good snap. Good punt. And Dwenger's not going to be able to pick this one up. And it takes a Luers bounce, and it's going to be touched up near the 34-yard line.
Water cutter let it drop a yard in front of him. And really, that's a cardinal sin in punt return. Because when you're down there on the sideline, Sean, you hear the special teams coaches yelling at the guys in the back before the play. All you do is catch the ball. You have to catch the ball. Because that's what happens. The ball hit and got another 15 yards for the Knights. So as a punt returner, your first job is to catch the ball.
They mark it at the 35. The Jolly and Company now back on the field as the Gold Helmets come up to the line. High formation now. Wide out left and right. Pichoni under center. Hudson the tailback. Here's a snap. They give it to him, trying to find some room through the middle. He finds some. Breaks through two tackles. Gets out to the midfield strike.
Powerful. Jordan Hudson's powerful. You saw it right there. Again, runs real low to the ground. But if he gets in the open, Sean, I'm telling you, look out. He is a special kind of talent. If he can stay healthy, he'll be a big help to the Saints this the rest of this year.
A 15-yard gainer that time as McGarry checks in for the Saints. And Cornwell checking out.
Yeah, 15.
Cornwell doing a fine job as a lead blocker on that previous play. First and 10 from the 50. Same I formation. Pichoni under center. Give to the tailback. Bounces it out to the right side. Finds the edge. 45. Puts his head down. Gets down to about the 44-yard line. 6-yard gain that time for Hudson.
Jordan on the stop. The defensive back took a shot from Jordan Hudson.
Yeah.
But I like the way Jordan Hudson's running with some force, just like who? Ambright.
That's right. Actually going to give him a gain of 7 that time. Down to the 43. Second and 3 coming up for the Saints. As Cornwell checks back in. This time a pro set. Wide out left and right. Here's a snap. Again, give it to Hudson through the left side. Has the first down inside the 40, down to about the 38.
And now, who's the biggest cheerleader on the sidelines over there on the far sideline is Coach Schwarzkopf. He is going crazy in a good way, Sean. Not
right.
A bad way, but in a good way, and rallying the kids on the sidelines to get up for their second.
So another first down at the 38-yard line of Bishop Luers for the Saints.
Sean, really, with their success running the ball on this drive, they have to believe at some point you might see a play action, or do you just keep burning the clock?
Well, let's see what they do here. One would think the Coach Garrett is probably setting up the play action when the safeties and corners start to bite.
Yeah, first down's a good time to do a play action.
From the I formation, here's a snap. Giving the tailback. Fighting for some yardage is Hudson again. He will get down to about the 41-yard line. Or check Sturm. That 36-yard line.
Sturm, and there's a Saint down.
Oh boy.
Looks like one of the big boys.
Yes. Yeah, it might be a leg.
trying to see who is not accounted for. All of us, maybe?
Well, wasn't he dinged up coming into the contest? A lot of Saints dinged up. Well, that's a gain of three, bringing up a second and seven for the Saints. They are attending to the player on the field. We're going to go ahead and step out for a little 30-second break. 14-7 is your score. Saints on top and driving here in the fourth quarter. Stick around, folks. SAC football on Redeemer Radio, 106.3 FM.
Successful coaches make changes to succeed by calling timeouts to make needed adjustments. For it's clear, no change equals no change. This is David X with Union Savings Bank in Fort Wayne. I started mortgage lending in 1988. Since then, I've been trusted by thousands of area homeowners. I offer low closing costs and great rates on home lending so you can save big money both up front and over the life of your loan. Make a change for the better when purchasing a different home or refinancing to lower your payment. Call timeout, get your mortgage statement in hand. Call me anytime for your free mortgage checkup. And make sure you compare. Call David X, 418-6191. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Welcome back to live action here, ladies and gentlemen. Fourth quarter of the Bishops Bowl 2016, where the Bishop Dwenger Saints are driving down the field with a 14-7 score in the lead right now as Olivas has helped off the field. Another injury for the Saints, Joe.
Steven Nix, number 57, the starting defensive end, is listed as his backup. So we'll see if Steven Nix now is going to pull double duty for the Saints.
Saints facing a second and seven off of the Jordan Hudson run that time.
74 is in the game, Sean. 74 is a number. That's Drew Dicer, 6'2", 220. That's a great number.
I know a guy that wore that number back in 86. Here's a snap from shotgun. They give it to, again, Jordan Hudson. Tries something through the middle. Gets down to the 35. Gain of one, maybe two. Going to bring up third and long for the Saints.
Well, the Knights are, they feel like the Saints are just going to try to run the ball here, and they are bringing everybody, which is why Jordan Hudson can't get going. Everybody is flying between the tackles to stop the run.
McGarry checks in.
Now it's an obvious passing down, I think.
I think you're right. We're going to call this a third and seven, so not much on that game clock. Ticking down, under 5 minutes to go now, 4:30 remaining in the contest. Trips right. Single setback, one left. Pagelny in the shotgun. Here's a snap. He rolls to the right. Has pressure. Throws downfield. Whale incomplete. Nobody there. And the drive is going to stall for the Bishop Dwenger Saints.
I think they go for it, Sean. Underwood was giving pressure for the Knights. But you're on the Knights, what, 35-yard line?
Yep.
Here comes the punting team. Try to coffin corner one here. Long field.
Make the Knights work for it. Let's see what they do. Pagelny is back in punt formation. Now, we've seen early on in the season a fake punt out of the Saints as well.
We've seen it, yeah, right, a couple times this season. So the punt team is still trickling people on. They were not ready to come onto the field.
No, they weren't.
They're coming out like one at a time here. It's
4, 3, 2, 1.
Take to the leg game.
They get the snap off, and Pagelny punts towards the corner. It's going to go out of bounds.
It's hard telling.
He tried for the corner, but it went out of bounds well before that as the official walks it past the 20 up to about the 22-yard line. Wow.
13-yard punt.
Yeah. Well, the special teams are going to get a talking to there from Bishop Dwenger. They were clearly not prepared for that play, and it showed not crisp at all.
This could be the final drive for the night, Sean. You just never know.
Let's see.
4:15 to go.
What the Knights can do on offense.
Saints on top, 14-7.
Nieves and company on the field for the Knights. From the shotgun and a single setback. Man in motion now. That's Hambright. They fake it to him. Give it to the edge on the left side. Great penetration as Charlton is stopped in the backfield and falls forward.
That's Riley Miller. Sean, some facts here. The home team has won the last four in this series. The last time Chris Schwarzkopf left Luers Field with a victory was 2010.
Wow. Well, if the Knights can't get it done in the next 3 minutes and 50 seconds, he's going to chalk up another victory here.
Let me throw this one at you, Sean. Kyle Lindsey is only one of two active coaches in the SAC that has a winning record against Bishop Dwenger. He is 2-1. The other coach is Kirk Tittman, who's 4-3.
Second and 11 now for the Knights. Two wideouts to the right side. Here's a give to Hambright, flowing to the right, looking for a seam. He won't find much there.
Now, this defense, this run defense now has looked pretty good. This is kind of what we've seen all season, Sean.
Yeah. Gain of a couple brings up third and nine now for the Bishop Luers Knights. Facing third and long, again, another, pass. Well, you got Jalen Charlton in the backfield, so third and nine is not necessarily a
guy that averages
down.
12 yards a carry. You're right.
That's right.
Let's not jump to conclusions.
No.
Godfather's sweating down there. I can see it from here.
I think he's closing a mortgage deal is what
he's
doing.
Is.
All right, so they spread things out. Single step back, twins right, twins left. Nieves in the shotgun. Defense gives the receivers plenty of room. He looks right. They try the jailbreak screen. They check off. Going right side. Double coverage. Up and incomplete that time. No good. They went for Gilly.
And Tommy Steele was right there in good coverage. And it looked like even Effinger was back there as well.
So Nieves chalks off the checks off the jailbreak screen and decides to go right. And it is no good. And Peyton Howe is now back in to kick this one away.
Should be great starting field position for the Saints. You have Watercutter and Effinger again back. This ball has to be caught in the air.
You know, it's interesting, Joe. Nobody in Northeast Indiana screens like Bishop Luers does.
Nobody.
And we haven't seen it tonight.
I was just thinking the same thing. You're exactly right. It's one of their best plays.
The pressure is on, but Peyton Howe somehow gets the ball away, makes it a great kick, takes a Bishop Luers bounce, but still, Dwenger will be set up with great field position at about their 41, maybe the 42-yard line. Wow, that's some composure there by Howe to get that ball away.
Everybody was coming.
Everybody was coming. They mark it at the 41-yard line with 2:26 remaining in the contest. Dwenger 14, Luers 7. Godfather, what do you have?
I think we have to credit the Saints defense on those no screens because I think they've tried to throw them, and Watercutter's got them prepared for it. I think he knows, like you said to Coach Lindsay, they do a nice job with screens. He took it away from them tonight.
Well, he's got Yanko up there to do that, too. Yeah.
They said he has a great sense for that. Yanko does.
I formation for the Saints. Give to the tailback. Bounces it out to the right side. They can't bring him down finally. After a second and third effort, I think that's Effinger on the carry.
That is Effinger. And right now, your number one goal is to hang on to the ball, protect the ball. Ball security at this point, Godfather.
That's what it's all about. Gain of five for Effinger after the third effort. Takes it north of the 45 to the 46-yard line. Go ahead, Godfather. You're live.
Yeah, and the Knights have got to be thinking, you know, make something happen. We talked about it. Fumble, pickoff, or turnover on downs. And with the clock working against them, they need the first two.
Second and five. I formation again for the Saints. Here's a snap. Give to the tailback through the middle. Effinger again with a big push. He may have it. Saints are pointing for another first down. Depends upon the spot. It's going to be close. And they are signaling for a first and 10 for the Saints. And a wait. Oh, no. That might be a little premature. As the white hat said, no. Don't put the ball there. Bring it back a little bit.
Yeah, interesting spot. So the referees are going to do the right thing and bring the chains out.
So it is in Bishop Luers territory at the 49. Just what part of the 49 is it is the question. Will it be a third and inches or a first and 10 for the Saints? I think they're going to be a little short on this one, Joe.
I think they've got it.
Well, yeah, after they put the chains down.
I waited. I held my decision until as long as I could.
Thank you, Captain Obvious.
Yeah.
First and 10 for the Saints. Again, two hard-nosed runs that time by Effinger. Moves the chains.
Hey, here's another some more fun facts on this series, Sean. Chris Schwarzkopf is 9-4 all-time against Bishop Luers.
Well, if they can control the ball and keep it on the ground, it'll tick up to 10. The clock has started. Under 2 minutes to go. 1 minute and 10 seconds remaining in the contest. Bishop Dwenger with a fresh set of downs. Again, I formation. Here is the snap. Tailback bouncing it out to the left side. Again, that's Effinger. He won't have much, and immediately Bishop Luers calls a timeout.
Yeah, they have to.
Yeah.
Sturm, Jimmy Sturm on the stop on the far side of the field, but playing a nice game tonight.
He sure has, absolutely. Okay, so 1-on-1 remaining, and the crowd starts to get thinner here at Bishop Luers. 14-7 is your score. We're going to step out for a 30-second break. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio, 106.3 FM.
Sverion Staffing, locally owned by the Pentenberg family, excels in finding the best candidates for industrial, clerical, customer service, non-clinical healthcare, IT, and professional direct hire placements. Sverion clients are accustomed to getting the right employees at the right time, every time. Sverion Staffing supports the proud excellence of the Dwenger Saints and the Luers Knights, both on the field and in the classroom. Whether you are seeking your next career move or searching for great employees, call us at 260-496-9900 or visit us on the web at sverion.com/ftwayne.
Back to live action in the waning moments of the Bishop's Bowl 2016, where the Bishop Dwenger Saints are on top and in control at the moment, 14-7 over the Bishop Luers Knights. 1 minute and 1 second remaining in the contest. Saints near midfield in Luers territory down to the 47, facing a 2nd and 8.
What is going on? Okay.
An interesting formation here. Double wings to the left side on the short side and double tights. As the quarterback tries an end around and slips, and that's going to be a loss of a couple on the play. And again, another timeout called by Bishop Luers.
Now, remember this last week, Sean, when we did a Concordia Dwenger game?
Yeah.
Remember Concordia's play calling late in the game?
Yeah.
When they had the lead.
Mm-hmm.
We all thought, well, they're going to run the clock, they're going to do it by the book, and this and that. No,
they're going to
pass plays.
Right.
They played to win.
Instead of playing not to lose.
It's going to be interesting to see what the Saints do here because this is 3rd and 10. Are you going to put it in the air like Concordia did last week when they had the lead, saying, listen, we're not going to give you the ball back. Okay, you're using your timeouts thinking we're going to run it here and punt it back to you? No. We're going to fake it, and we're going to throw it, and we're going to get the first down, and we're going to win this game. We're going to play to win. It's going to be interesting to see what the Saints choose to do here.
Timeout on the field called by Bishop Luers. That's their 2nd in short order here. I wonder, do they have one remaining? They've got one left? Yeah, they've got one left. And again, we're under 1 minute, 57 seconds remaining in the contest. And now Bishop Dwenger, after the timeout on 3rd and 11, lines up under center. Quarterback decides to push right through the middle. Stays on his feet, and they finally blow the whistle.
About a 4-yard pickup, so there you go. The Saints are another timeout by Luers. The Bishop Luers Knights will get the ball back.
That they will.
The Saints would rather punt it back to them and take their chances with that great defense.
Just a reminder, folks, tonight here at Bishop Luers, the Bishop Luers Smoker kicks off at 7 p.m. The festivities under the tent, great food, great fun, prizes to be won, and great hospitality here by Bishop Luers as they host their annual smoker to support the athletic program. And show up early, get a good seat.
Oh, it's a great time. Listen, you won't be disappointed if you come out to that smoker. There is so much food and fun and games and TV and football. And wow, what a great time.
10 by 10 by Godfather.
Godfather, they're glossy too.
That's right.
Sean, and I'm not saying that Concordia's choice was right and Dwenger's tonight was wrong as far as what to do when you're playing with the lead at this point in the game. It's just decisions that coaches have to
That's
make.
That's right. But there was an attitude on display there by Concordia, Joe.
Yeah, we're winning this game.
Yes. All right, Pacioni in to punt this one away on 4th and long. One man back deep for Luers. Here's a kick. Nice kick by Pacioni. That is Gaston. It goes through his hands, going towards the end zone.
He touched it.
The ball is loose in
the
end zone.
That's a touchdown. That's got to be a touchdown.
They call touchback. They say he did not touch the ball.
I thought it hit Gaston and went off his hands and went into the end zone.
Well, the way he was chasing it, it looked like it. But, again, no call. And a touchback is called. And Coach Schwarzkopf makes his way onto the field and wants a decision.
Well, obviously, listen, the referee was a lot closer than we were.
Oh, sure.
So, I mean, obviously he was standing right next to him. Obviously, Gaston did not touch it.
Right.
And it went in the end zone. That's a touchback.
So the Bishop Luers Knights will take over 1st and 10 from their 20-yard line with 42 seconds remaining on the clock. And again, with the speedster, now Charlton checks out for some reason.
I'm I'm not sure why.
Wouldn't you want Charlton in the game
I
at
would.
This point?
I sure would.
Wow. I mean, if anyone is capable of breaking a play with 42 seconds, it's Jalen Charlton, and he's on the sidelines right now. Well, interesting call here. Let's see what they do here on first and 10. Two wideouts left, two wideouts right, and a single setback as Nieves is in the shotgun. Here is a snap. He rolls to his left, looking to throw. Looking, he's got pressure.
Yanko,
he has
fumble.
Got him. The ball is on the ground.
Yanko forced a fumble there.
And let's see. Do they retain possession? They do. So another sack by Frankie Yanko on the season.
That's seven for the season, two on the night.
And Luers cannot stop the clock. 20 seconds remaining in the contest. Will they be able to get another play off is the question.
They don't know what to play.
They don't know what play to call. We're down to 10 seconds now. They get the snap off. And again, Nieves looks to throw. He's got pressure. He steps into it, throws over the middle, incomplete pass. And that is going to stop the clock with 4.9 seconds remaining. So, again, let's talk about it. Third and 15 now for the Saints, for the Knights, as the ball is resting at the 15-yard line.
You got to believe this is the last play, Sean, barring a penalty on the defense.
4.9 seconds remaining. 14-7 is your score. Saints on top, and they are one play away, maybe two plays away from breaking this three-year drought against the Bishop Luers Knights. Blitz coming from Bishop Dwenger. They pick it up. He's looking to throw. No, they finally catch him in the pocket. He throws the ball. Incomplete pass. The game is over.
The Saints win one here. Third time's a charm, Sean. This is the third straight home game for this series, and the Knights had won the previous two, so third time's a charm here at Luers Field for the Bishop Dwenger Saints.
That's going to do it, ladies and gentlemen. The teams meet at midfield. We're going to try and get some comments from Coach Chris Schwarzkopf on the win as Godfather makes his way to find Coach Chris. We're going to go ahead and step out for a 30-second break and allow him to do that. 14-7 is your final score. Stick around. Our postgame show is up right after this break. You're listening to SAC Football on Redeemer Radio 106.3 FM.
He has counted to infinity twice. He once set a land speed record on a surfboard. Bruce Springsteen calls him the boss. He is the most fascinating man alive.
I don't always buy diamonds, but when I do, I prefer Peter Franklin Jewelers. Stay sparkly, my friend.
And we are back to live action here at Bishop Luers High School with Joe Wharton. I'm Sean McBride, reminding you that this broadcast is brought to you by Bishop Luers High School, a Catholic educational community that instills in each student dignity, integrity, respect, and responsibility. Catch the Luers spirit by visiting them online at www.bishoplewers.org. Well, reporting your final score from the Bishops Bowl 2016, the Bishop Dwenger Saints end the drought 14-7 over the Bishop Luers Knights with a good win here at Bishop Luers Stadium. So we're going to go ahead and get some final numbers together with Jose Lopez and try and get Coach Schwarzkopf down on the field for his comments with the victory with the Godfather of football. But Joe Wharton, again, two quick scores by the Bishop Dwenger Saints, and then they went dry.
Yeah, we talked about it during break. I think they had, with 3 minutes to go in the first quarter, the Saints had 14 points and were not able to get in the end zone after that.
We've got Coach Chris Schwarzkopf with the Godfather. Take it away, Godfather.
Coach Schwarzkopf, exciting Bishop. Battle of the Bishops tonight. Ahead 14 points, and you're able to hang on and win this ball game with a great defensive effort.
Well, thank you. Bishop Luers has a great team. They run the ball very, very well. And that was our, what we had to do is we had to take stop the run. And in that third quarter, that's where they got caught up with the running game. So they do a great job.
Well, I'll tell you what, you're in the initial part of the game, your offense just looked like it was unstoppable. It looked like it was going to be a long night for the night.
Well, we started the game off with a nice drive. That was good. To go up 7-0 was a nice drive. And I was proud of the effort in the third quarter. The defense got the ball back, put it on offense after that, but we had a nice drive in the fourth quarter.
Well, I'll tell you, it looked like Bishop Dwenger football to me. It looked like they were playing with a purpose tonight.
They did. you know, I'd like to thank everybody out there that wrote the letters to these guys. We did a little letter writing campaign. Anybody who, and this is a plea to anybody else out there that ever played Bishop Dwenger football, write us, tell us what number you wore, and tell us what it means to wear that jersey. And write that number to the guy wearing that jersey. It means a lot. And those guys read those letters tonight and meant the world to them.
Hey, guys, I'll tell you what. I got chills just listening to Coach talk about that. And, hey, thanks for all you former Dwenger Saint players that took time out, like Coach said. And, hey, it made a huge difference. These guys came out on fire.
Thanks very much. I'm really proud of them. We've been through a lot of adversity, and this is important. So it's big. Thank you very much.
Congratulations. Thanks, Coach.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that Coach Schwarzkopf commenting about his 14-7 victory here over the Bishop Luers Knights. And, Joe Warden, do you have some final stats for us?
I do, guys. Here we go. Bishop Luers Nieves, the senior quarterback here on senior night, 3 of 18 for 31 yards, one interception, no touchdowns. Charlton, 20 carries. Jalen Charlton, 20 carries, 170 yards, one touchdown.